Yes, I was.
Connecticut.
Every morning.
Unless I go over today to Dick's Liquor and pick up a quart of vodka. So, Dick's Liquor over in Las Vegas, New Mexico.
Well, you know, isn't 17 your lucky number?
Yes, it is.
Well, maybe it's time.
I thought.
We'll
maybe
go celebrate.
You are just an idiot.
You know, maybe they'll get drunk and try to grab the rattlesnake.
We'll have a happy ending.
Well, I might die, Bernard.
Well, did you tell him the story that happened to you like 2 weeks ago, Don? When you came stumbling out from
home? No. I've already told the story about
behind Mountain Lion Mesa with your pistol in one hand and his T-shirt all torn up.
Oh, God. Yes, I told that story.
Two things I thought is that he started drinking because it was 5:30 in the morning and you were off the air.
Right.
And nobody could find you. And, of course, I was hysterical looking all over the ranch, driving all over. Or somehow dementia had set in already. Something. I mean, I couldn't figure out. And when I saw you even, I thought, why is your shirt all torn up? And why are you that far down, you know, behind the mesa there? What were you doing? I didn't see your truck.
Well, no, I got my truck stuck in a ditch.
Well, you drove it into a ditch.
Right.
That's not good.
That's troublesome, too, Chuck.
Sure it is. Of course it is.
That's a judgment thing.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it's like when you decide to get married. That's a judgment thing as well, isn't it? You know, like you're some pretty young thing watching the city and think, oh, that looks good. Well, let's get married.
Okay, well, 12 years later.
I know, honey. I'm just kidding around.
Yes,
okay, so we have to go now. Thank you for your visit, and it's always nice to see
you. Hey, you know, I thought Senator Biden was really good.
He is good. We
like
him a lot.
He has great energy, too.
Right. So.
And I thought Edwards and Kerry were pretty good yesterday, too.
Good. I'm happy you approve of the guests we've had on the program.
have you tried to escape the Zionists?
Yeah. It is 10 minutes after the hour here at the I'm Swimming program.
Is she digging a tunnel?
No, I'm threatened every day, so I'm afraid to.
No, don't leave that impression. So. Anyway, here's Charles with the news. Good morning, Charles.
Good morning, I-Man. Some heartbreaking pictures are coming from the scene of this terrible school fire in India. Dozens of children's blackened bodies are being carried out one by one while hundreds of adults wail in grief. Officials in India now confirming...
Pack and a half, probably.
Do you smoke at all?
Yes. Probably about a half.
Wow.
A
that's good.
That's even worse.
Yeah.
The single worst thing, having been a smoker, it's a single, I don't even know.
What, does it keep you from eating another pizza? Or?
Obviously not.
Oh, that's nice.
Wow.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it?
Where does that come from?
What are you?
I have to be honest. No,
you don't.
I'm trying to help Chris here.
I'm not trying to help him by making him feel bad about being fat.
I'm not going to lie. I could help him. It'd be like me saying to you, honey, that interview was really great, and it sucked, you know? I mean, I'm not going to tell you that.
Well, we do it all the time.
It works.
It's a quarter after the hour. Thank you for this.
I can help Chris, if you want.
Why don't you and Chris, maybe we'll make you call Chris from the phone out of the studio.
Maybe you could just send the iJet and I'll come out and hang out for a couple of weeks and get a feel about what's going on.
You can come out here and eat dirt for a month. You'd lose about 100 pounds.
You need a C-130 to get you out.
Oh, that's nice.
But I'll tell you one thing you can take to the bank. When John Kerry is our president, every day that he is in the White House, every single day that he is the president for all Americans, he will tell the American people the truth.
Well, that's one with hope.
Well, it's not necessary.
No, it's not.
And a hush falls over the crowd.
Now, Brian Williams is coming up, and he's the apparent. He is the successor to Tom Brokaw. One of you guys told me this happened. I didn't see it. How would I see it?
Well, you see everything. Somehow.
No, I don't.
I saw the Shaq interview.
No, that was... because the only time I can turn on a television here is late at night. I mean, at 4:30 in the afternoon when the news comes on, I'm out with the kids in a barn or on a horse or something.
TiVo, DirecTV, all these gadgets. Yeah,
I understand all of that, but I didn't see this.
Yeah,
that's my point.
That's not the impression that was left.
That's a vicious lie.
And he's an idiot, and he said a certain thing, and it turns out not to be the case, and we have it on tape.
That's not
and now he's coming out in 5 minutes.
That is not true.
Brian Williams looks really good doing the news.
But wait a minute. Hold it. This goes back. It's not just this episode from last night.
What?
He's been a moron, you have said.
Yeah.
For months.
More than a lightweight who cocks his head sideways like...
Why did they do that? And the convoluted
questions... Well, I think at this point...
Yeah.
I think at this point, I'm a team player. I have great allegiance to Rick and particularly to Bob Wright. And I think at this point...
And you have no principles.
Well, no wonder you're supporting Senator Kerry.
Oh, no kidding. Good Lord.
Dude, you're...
What does that mean?
You need help.
You guys are perfect. You should be his running mate.
You need help. You need lots of help.
Dude, you are hanging out way too much in Scarborough country.
Honest to God.
The real deal coming up. Joe's real deal. The Iron Man flip-flopping.
You guys wouldn't have a platform. You'd have a trampoline. Jesus.
I ain't looking to block you up. Shock or knock or lock you up. I ain't looking for you to feel like me. See like me. Or be like me. All I really wanna do is baby be friends with you.
I'm just in the morning.
Are you losing your...
It's just 4687 on your phone to correctly identify this tune, and this artist will win, that I'm going to play in a second here, will win an Imus iPod, Apple iPod, rather. It's a 15-gigabyte iPod that holds about 3,500 songs. God. It's the Imus in the Morning iPod Today giveaway from BMW and Apple, who have created the first seamless integration of iPod and automobile. So y'all go to iPodBMW.com for all the details. Here be the tune now.
You've been telling me you're a genius since you were 17. In all the time I've known you, I still don't know what you mean. The weekends at the college didn't turn out like you planned. The things that top the knowledge I can't understand.
Okay. Who is that and what's the name of that tune? 1-800-370-IMUS. I understand Annie Rooney was in yesterday and recorded some observations on, the I-Man, unfortunately.
Andy Rooney's head is spinning. Andy?
Like the proverbial kitten dropped in the Cuisinart, I feel dizzy right now. As do you if you've been listening to and trying to follow the Don Imus radio program. I believe Imus really should run for elective office. He's got all the indispensable qualifications, bright, informed, and able to adopt more simultaneous positions than a red-headed sexual compulsive in a room full of drunk nymphomaniacs. The other day, Imus had a couple of Johns on his program, Kerry and Edwards. And anyway, Senator Kerry, not known for his, consistency of views, had the audacity to say the following of President Bush.
The president's word doesn't mean anything. He himself is the flip-flopper of all flip-floppers.
What's he, nuts? Bush isn't the flip-flopper of all flip-floppers. Nor is our Massachusetts money bags manipulator himself, despite evidence to the contrary of galactic proportions. No, the title holder, incontestably, is Mr. Imus, who in the past 24 hours has once again altered his views through 180-degree swings on, everything. Remember his allegiance to the Los Angeles Lakers? His new post-Phil Jackson position is that the Staples Center should fall in on them. His unswerving, unalterable, immovable, over my cold, dead body prohibition of a guest appearance, ever, this life or next, by Hillary Rodham Clinton? You heard it. You know, the buck-tooth, keg-leg, graft-groveling thief has really been a pretty good senator. Jesus, that's code for Booker, Bernie. Look for the former shrew to make the iGuest power rotation a week from Monday. And now, of course, his most absolute dictum of all. Author appearances on the Imus in the Morning program. the unconditional injunction, held the fatwa that states, appear here first or die, obliterated by who? Kitty Kelly, the snarky, poison-penned, dysfunctional dirt disher who's going to appear on everything, up to and including the Jetsons, before she appears on Imus to peddle her new Bash Bush book. Has somebody videotaped the I-Man having sex with a paisley chicken and messengered it to Deidre? Yes, Rick Kaplan. And so it goes. Adherence to principle, subject to change, without notice. Oh, by the way, favorite campaign bumper sticker seen so far? I voted for John Kerry before I voted against him. Sad.
Shut up. That's ugly and unnecessary. 25 minutes past the hour, some sad news. General Charles Sweeney died this morning. May remember, he flew on both the Hiroshima and Nagasaki bombing missions, in which we caught the Japanese attention and persuaded them that maybe that initial effort to bomb Pearl Harbor was not a great idea, and they ought to pack it in, which they did. He was the author of War's End, an eyewitness account of America's last atomic mission. General Sweeney was how old, Bernard?
He was 84 years old. By the way, that book started really all this procession of all these war books. That was really the first successful one.
So a man, Tom Brokaw, ripped off General Charles Sweeney, died this morning, 84 years of age.
True American hero.
And that's the way it is. Well, didn't we have him on a few times?
Yeah, the I-Man broke the book here.
A charming gentleman.
Is it? Great guy. Great man. Had about 12 kids. Smoking cigars, sitting back in the office at 80 years old.
Not a bad run.
God bless him.
So, I'll sign up for that now, Chuck.
He actually piloted the Nagasaki mission.
Flew the, what was that aircraft?
Boxcar.
Box car, yeah.
He was on the plane with Tibbetts and Enola Gay and piloted the second one himself.
Yeah. There's a little advice for you here, I started to say Ahmed, but Tojo. Oh, whatever. Chris Carlin's in the studio and is refusing to report on the Tour de France. Instead, is focusing on, well, good news, though, that Todd Hamilton, Chicken Jack's nephew, was four under through 17 at the British Open. And what did he do on the 18th?
Do not have that yet. I think he's still playing 18. They showed a little bit of it on TV a few minutes ago, but he's doing a good job. Be right in the mix there. Got a chance.
Who's leading?
Two guys, Thomas LeVay and Thomas LeVay is the only one. He hasn't teed off yet. He's at 5 under, and Todd is tied with Vijay Singh and a couple others at 4 under.
Pretty heady company.
Absolutely.
What else going on in the world of sports, Chris?
Well, Kobe stays with the Lakers, 7 years, $136 million, all that cash to drive the team into the ground. Kenyon Martin traded to the Nuggets.
Raping the fans. The ticket prices.
Yeah.
No dinner, no movie.
Raping Jerry Buss, too.
I probably could have doubled out the dinner movie comment, but that's fine, Lou.
Kenyon Martin traded to the Nuggets from the Nets for 3 number 1 picks. So the
good
Nets.
Get out. He was a horrible player.
He was great.
Good.
And the Nets are finished. Nets are finished now.
How about Jason?
Jason's good, but he needed Kenyon there to get him the ball to finish.
Oh, I see.
They're all going to leave now.
Yeah. How do you think Jason feels this morning now that Kenyon's gone after he signed that contract last year? Of course, he's still collecting $100 million.
I wouldn't want to be Jumana this morning.
Oh, come on. Yeah, I mean, we just don't need that. We're going to talk with Steve from Kalamazoo, Michigan.
All right.
Let's shut this off. We'll talk to him now, Lou. Good morning, Steve. How are you?
Good morning, I-Man.
What's going on, baby?
Oh, nothing. Just making it happen. Just working.
What are you doing?
I'm making eyeglasses.
Sounds like you're on something.
Pushing people around. Well, it's early, you know.
Okay. Who was that singing that song, and what was the name of the song?
That was Steely Dan, Reeling in the Years.
Guess what you just won?
Yeah. Did I get myself an iPod from the I-Man?
Yeah. Yes, you did. A 15-gigabyte iPod. You can put 3,500 Steely Dan songs on your iPod, though.
Are you going to program it for me with all those Steely Dan songs?
There's only one Steely Dan song I could ever really deal with, and that was that one.
And we just heard it.
Yeah.
And some no-dos, too.
Really, really, after the guitar intro, they pretty much lost me. In fact, after the opening guitar lick, I was pretty much finished. So.
Well, me too, obviously.
Anyway. What's your favorite radio station?
WKMI.
You want Joseph Abood's version of that song?
Let's hear it.
Reeling in the queers?
Oh, shut up, you idiot.
I love it, Dawn.
Steve, hang on. Don't hang up, because if you hang up, then we can't send you your iPod.
Won't hang up.
All right, baby.
All right.
Changes here, but other than that, it's just... No problem.
Attention, all architects.
Here we have share a prison cell with someone, well, we think... I don't know. I mean, who, other than white-collar criminals, who else goes there?
We're told that women in the federal prison system are housed in dorm-style facilities or rooms with double or triple bunks. They must work as orderlies, food service workers, or groundskeepers and are paid 12 cents to 40 cents an hour. They can have approved visitors on weekends.
Aren't they able to let them make tennis shoes, then?
Miss Stewart will be allowed to keep money in an inmate trust account at a prison commissary.
Sure.
Where she could spend as much as $290 a month on items such as detergent, shampoo, personal hygiene items, junk food, and radio headsets.
Hmm. Well, the girl got to get off the junk food.
That's not good news, is it? No.
No.
Put that time to good use.
Yeah.
That khaki...
She needs to lose about 70 pounds.
Well, here, this is good news, then, because they're issued, as we've discovered, khaki uniforms, which consist of a shirt and elastic waistband pants, I mean.
That's hot.
From somebody who knows something about elastic waistband pants.
Yeah, that's a great comment, Connor.
They're still too tight.
Well, not going to be pretty, is it? So,
Better not hit your ass passing no wind.
Speaking of fat girls, Senator Hillary Clinton now is going to speak at the Democratic Convention, right?
Yes, sir. Another person who knows probably something about elastic waistband pants.
Yeah. And Ryan Santa Reverend Al is going to speak.
Reverend Al is on the list.
So... When he popped out, that probably will be a good speech. I mean, he's...
Yes.
He doesn't make any sense, but he doesn't make any sense, and he does it well.
He makes it in a very... He makes no sense in a very entertaining way.
That's a colorful brother.
Yeah. We have him on this program, as a matter of fact.
All right, here now on the I Miss the Morning program, Reverend Al Sharpton.
Last week, Jada Kiss's new record, Kiss of Death, debuted at number one on the Billboard 200. Not an extraordinary feat for a rap CD, but what is unusual is its first breakout single, Why, it used the traditional hip-hop lexicon of bitches and players busting caps with nines while high on chronic and gin and juice in favor of election year political commentary. Commentary that subsequently has caused quite the controversy, as Why poses the question, why did Bush knock down the towers? Now, you don't have to be Colin Powell's kid to know that line's going to be censored on everything from the radio edit single to the MTV video. But the concept I have difficulty with is why Y's message is altered when the similar point of view expressed by that four-eyed baby Huey in the baseball cap Michael Moore in his controversial film Fahrenheit 9-1-1 is free to be promoted in the media with a frequency greater than those ads for Levitra, Viagra, and Cialis. Which, by the way, for all you tragically unhip, old bay cracker pecker woods, is not the names of the women in Destiny's Child. But why is Moore's agenda protected by the auspices of the First Amendment, while Jadakiss has his creative hands tied and critical tongue silenced by the gags of censorship? I'll tell you why. Because Moore is nothing more than one of those who he condemned in his book, aptly titled Stupid White Man. If Kiss of Death was released by the Dave Matthews Band, it would be Album of the Week at Kmart. If Jada Kiss was Josh Groban, Why would be performed on that stage in toto at Rockefeller Center next Friday morning on the Today Show, while that twinkie midget Katie Couric did one of her chiclet tooth overbite white girl dance routines. But it is not and will not. So how can this vital message be exposed and Jada Kiss get his political voice heard? I'll tell you how. You get the Flatlanders to cover it. And then it'll be played every hour on the Amos in the Morning program.
You know, that's not a bad point, by the way. Is it?
No.
Well, the Rev making some sense.
Yeah.
Well, I'm saying. 20 minutes till the hour here on the I Miss in the Morning program. And we're already the stage 12, I believe it is today, right, Chris?
Stage 12, correct.
Of the Tour de France, and they're heading into the Pyrenees.
Yes, they are.
And it started a couple hours ago, didn't it?
It should have, yeah. I don't have any new updates on it.
Hey, Dave, why don't you get channel 602 on my DirecTV here? Let's see where we are in this race, how Lance is doing.
Get the I-Man a little OLN.
Here's Bert from Columbus, Georgia on line one.
Hello, Amos.
How you doing, baby?
All right, how's it going? I got you a button here. Political button.
You got what?
A political button. You know how these people make these little buttons they put on their thing when they're for the candidate?
What do you do down there in Columbus, Georgia?
What do I do? Mm-hmm. I do nothing.
You don't do anything?
No, I have a bad back. Nah, I roof houses and do construction work and stuff.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, and I ride horses and, you know, stuff like that. I got some pretty neat, I don't have any myself, but some friends of mine have some nice Arabian and some quarter horses.
Sure.
Yeah, and the one I ride is called Rock and Roll.
All right. How'd you hurt your back?
Well, I was roofing and picked up a bundle of shingles and turned wrong.
Did you fall off the roof or you just turned
wrong? No, I fell off a roof before, but it didn't hurt my back when I fell off the roof.
I see.
Yeah, I fell off before, but it was because I was,
drunk.
Huh?
You were drunk.
No, I was. I wasn't drunk. I was, I just misstepped on the ladder. I have been drunk before in my life, though.
Oh, yeah, well, that's fine. So have I.
Yeah, and, but I was just wanting to know, if I send you this button, it says flip-flop carry, and it's got him, you know, it's a dual picture of Kerry. Will that change your mind and maybe you might could support the president again, redneck President Bush?
No.
No? You couldn't support any kind of redneck president?
Well, I'm going to vote for Senator Kerry.
Are you? Yeah. Well, good luck. And
I don't agree, by the way, Bert, yeah. I don't agree with him about anything.
You don't agree with Kerry about anything?
No.
Oh, really? You
no.
just want to vote for him?
I'm going to vote for him because I like him.
Oh, so that means you're going to vote for Kerry to keep President Bush back in.
Well, whatever.
Yeah. Well, I mean...
Well, if President Bush is reelected, I'm not going to kill myself.
Well, me either. And if Kerry is elected, I'm not going to kill myself. I'm just going to go out and kill, you know, my horse.
Let me just say this to you, Bert. Yeah. You do sound like the kind of guy that MSNBC would have helicopters over your house as you're barricaded in there with a shotgun
there
in some kid's
go.
Mouth.
There you go. Listen, let me ask you this. You ever heard that song, the new song says, Save a Horse, Ride a Cowboy?
Oh, yes, I have. Well, isn't that Big and Rich?
Yeah, Big and Rich. My version of that song is Save a Horse, Ride a Cowgirl.
That'll be fine, Bert. Go back in the trailer. There's a fire in the stove. It's 17 till the hour. Now all the young things, she lose the lose. Shake it, baby doll. Shake it on the floor. She don't shake it like a mother.
Double raise.
Mr. Director, Mr. Ivy, how are you guys?
Well, how
are
you doing?
How are you doing?
Thank you so much for talking so kindly about us. We heard you on the radio. We had to put that in the advertisers for the book. I'm a says these two morons. We set the race back 200 years. Oh, not OJ.
We are you.
Not Ebonics. No, these two guys. Don't get us started on OJ. He sent all the kids back. He's ruined if any kid named Orenthal. No, you can see the kid in school now, you know, in grade school. Timmy here, Sally here, Orenthal guilty. I mean, here.
If your radio
sounds funny in the morning. You're listening to Imus in the morning.
Here's the lineup for Lord. Here's the lineup for Lord. Girl, I'm like Domino Pizza. If you don't come in the first 30 minutes, the next one's free.
The next book is going to be Squeegee Tips.
Fives are back.
CBS Sports, doing some special coverage for the United States Open, is the author of The Mad Dog 100, which was a New York Times bestseller, and one half of Mike and the Mad Dog, Christopher Mad Dog Russo. Good morning, Mr. Russo.
Good morning, Don. Thanks for having me today. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing well. Hanging in there.
Are the Williams sisters hurt?
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, they are.
If you think that the Williams sisters are bypassing the U.S. Open because they need a little time off or they're a little bored with tennis, I don't buy it. I think they're legitimately hurt. I mean, Serena had arthroscopic surgery. Venus hasn't played since that abdominal strain at Wimbledon. They are legitimately hurt. Now, don't you get that? That puts, in my eyes, a huge asterisk next to the winner who wins this U.S. Open on the ladies' side. And I know you want to get to that. I heard you earlier this morning talking about the phone calls that McEnroe was taking last night because I was trying to call up myself and get on. Because the U.S. Open scheduling here down with this weather in New York has been an abomination, which I'm sure you're very much aware of.
Well, no, I wasn't.
Well,
what are they going to do? It rained.
Don, let me ask you a question. How do you allow four women to play two matches today, completions of suspension matches, round of 16, and then come back tonight to play a doubleheader? How is that possible? So we have two matches going on this morning, and the winners are going to have to come back and play Capriati and Justine Enna later on tonight.
Have some pasta. Carb up.
Oh, come on. Now, you can't play two matches in one day.
Take some Xenadrine.
Of course you can.
No, you can't. And then throw in the fact, how come we got to have the men's players play four consecutive matches day after day after day after day? Because we got to get on TV for Sunday? And this never happened in 35 years of a Grand Slam. Never. It's never happened. Do you read what McEnroe said today in the New York Times?
No.
He said that by the third match, you're going to have a lousy quality tennis match, and there's no way these guys can play four matches in 4 days. It's absurd. But they're doing it to make sure CBS has its TV coverage in store for Saturday and Sunday.
And
but, you know, it's funny. I find it a little odd that both Americans, Roddick and Agassi, they somehow got their matches in, but the other European players did not, which means Roddick doesn't have to play four in a row, nor does Agassi. Roger Federer does. It's absurd.
It's the U.S. Open.
Oh, come on, Don. Stop with the Patriot games, please, will you? I mean, let's do the tournament right. Do the tournament right.
Well, what would you suggest they do?
I suggest they move off the weekend and, you know, do it right and play the finals on Sunday or Monday or Monday and Tuesday to give these guys a day off. And to have two women play a suspension match today when they've had all week to complete the darn thing.
Guess what?
Have them play a suspension match today, complete it, and then come back 7 hours later to play Capriati, who's been sitting out for 3 days.
Guess what?
That's an unfair competitive advantage.
Guess what?
Nobody cares.
We have a network to run. The little sissy boy and sissy girl tennis players can suck it up, get out there and hit the ball. It's going on Sunday. Case closed. Let's move on.
Come on, Don. That's not the way to look at it. I mean, geez, you want to finish or not?
No. Bottom line, Sid. Chris.
Don't call me Sid.
I'm sorry. I made a mistake. I'm sorry.
That's an egregious error.
Bottom line, we're looking at the bottom line. The little sissy tennis players have to suck it up and play two or three matches in a row and get over it.
Well, why don't they play five matches in a row?
Oh, whatever.
How about if it rains today where they can play a triple header next? Well, when does this end, Don? They haven't played a match in 4 days.
Well.
What do you mean, well?
Well, first of all, why can't they play in the rain?
Because you're going to break your leg.
Well,
Ask you a question, Mr. U.S. Open. Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Why did Andy Roddick, why did they schedule him last night to play his match and not have the two women play their suspended matches?
Oh, what do you think I wanted to watch last night on USA? Andy Roddick or four fat bimbos play tennis? Huh? Hello?
Yes, I'm with you.
Oh, you know, I want to watch the people
who
are...
Chuck.
Ought to be down at the Duke University rice diet after walling around on the tennis court or watch Andy Roddick.
Don, let me tell you something right now. If anybody out there in Imus Radio Land thinks that Don does not watch sports, it is a sad state of affairs that Don is sitting there at 11:15, he has to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning, is watching John McEnroe take phone calls about Venus Carolinas, for God's sake.
It's unbelievable. You're right.
That was good, though. He's good, wasn't he?
That is sick. That is sick.
Well, first of all, Wyatt and I were playing chess.
Oh, yeah, I know. You and Wyatt are into the chess deal right now. I know that.
So?
I know that. My kid still has pink eye, so it's still a disaster in the Russo household.
Pink eye?
Well, I told you my kids had pink eye a couple weeks ago when I called in.
Wow. Well, do they still have it?
It's moved around the house, yes.
Oh, it has. Well, I'm sure you're coping well with it, aren't you?
Staying at a motel.
Did you move out of the house?
Oh, I want to, my friend.
You are really just a horrible father.
And I guess who's coming to dinner in a week? Molly and Tony.
Your parents?
Yes, Tom.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Well, we're going to eat at McDonald's every night, but other than that, everything's okay.
What's the deal with Pete Sampras? I mean, that whole big stage phony event, and he gets the thing starts crying.
Come on, Donovan. You know, I can't figure you out. On the one hand, you want to see Roddick. On the other hand, you don't want to see Sampras, who won 14 Grand Slams.
I want to see him play. Why isn't he playing?
Because he's
lazy.
Answer that question in about 3 years, because he'll be bored stiff, and they'll probably want to come back and play. They never can retire. Officially. But,
yeah.
You know, Sampras is a great professional. I mean, he never gave anybody any grief. He gave everything he had. He won 14 Grand Slam championships. He kept himself out of trouble.
Hey, by the
parents, it's hard to knock Sampras. I mean, he might be a little boring, not very colorful, but as far as his actual career is concerned, I mean, it's pretty solid, right?
We're talking with Chris Russo from WFAN and CBS Sports. And by the way, CBS Sports for the coverage of this U.S. Open, which you've done some little segments that I've not seen, but maybe I'm sure you have them on the tape. Maybe you can bring them and drop them off in the office. And
maybe I will do that, yes.
Watch them on a slow day here.
It better be very slow.
By the way, back to the Williams sisters, they're out in the back of Mr. Cal's limo twisting themselves into pretzels. How come they can't play tennis? That's the question we have here.
Well, they have been, what did Bud Collins say about that?
Oh, well, you know, he said...
Come on. I know Bud is, but is Bud being a little apologetic for the Williams sisters?
Like you.
Yeah, like you.
I'm not being apologetic, Don. Well, what can I tell you? You think Serena Williams, for some reason, decided she was going to take the U.S. Open off when she's won all these Grand Slam championships and she's trying to defend her title? That's not true. She had arthroscopic surgery.
Yeah.
On a high day, I can't figure you out.
Well, Joe, I don't know.
Why are you so cynical? What do you think? Use your noodle. You think Serena Williams... You want to come to the Australian Open? She didn't want to go down to Australia? I'll buy it. But you're telling me that Serena Williams wanted to bypass the U.S. Open in New York City when she's a defending champion? Don, wake up, please.
You wake up, Fruit Loops. She's lazy. She's lazy.
I'll tell you right now, I hope Sid kicks the heck out of you, Pod.
That is not going to happen, by the way. That is not going to happen.
I'm going to knock him out.
Get out of here. Separated at birth, Chris. Gilbert Brown, Jennifer Capriati.
Who's the first one?
Gilbert Brown.
She is chunky, my God.
Man.
Toss in a salad, Jennifer, please.
I mean, honest to God.
She is fat. I mean, she puts that patriot, you know, that American star flag on her. My God, she looks like a Goodyear blimp.
Hey, speaking of McEnroe, I did happen to see that. I thought he was very eloquent. I thought it was, frankly, touching, his dissertation on Venus Carolinas, didn't you?
Yeah, listen, he loves Carolinas. He grew up in Howard Beach. I mean, they played in the U.S. Open Final. Carolinas was loved by the players. He was never a great player. I mean, you know, he only won, I think he only won one Grand Slam. He won an Australian Open once. He never was a great player, but he was, you know, he was theatrical. I mean, he had the long hair. He always played. He had a lot of personality. And, you know, when he died, I heard you say it a little while ago, that terrible act, you know, when stupid, bizarre death. When he died, you know, all those tennis players, they all showed up. Ford was there, and European players, which showed you that he had a lot of lot of friends on the men's tour.
I just wondered why nobody's ever, I mean, it would seem like a great...
good book.
Something. Man, the guy was...
One day I think you're going to do that. One day I think you'll see that.
And Parcells starts Sunday. How's he going to do this year?
Let's hope he loses.
Why?
To Atlanta.
Why?
Well, I don't know. I got Mike. You think I need the Cowboys to go 12-4? My God, I'd go out my ears. Dallas Cowboy football. You know that.
You're making a lot of sense there, Fruit Loops.
You can't be rooting against...
What do you mean rooting against? rooting against? I mean, what am I supposed to root for? Am I
you're rooting against
Cowboys?
No, you're rooting against Mike.
No, I'm not. I'm rooting against... No, I'm not.
Guy lost 12 pounds flogging your book for you, you dope. I mean, you got to show some loyalty here. You guys been working together 15 years.
Speaking of which, the Mad Dog 100, a New York Times bestseller.
Yes, I'm well aware of that.
I love you.
Who's going to win the men's side? On Sunday.
Jeez, what a joke. Based on this issue now, I don't think Federer can win four matches in a row. I think Roddick will beat Agassi in the back-to-back. I would say Roddick on the men's side, and I would say Justine and on the woman's side.
Girl's got to get her teeth fixed, man.
Yeah, she's a pain in the neck, too.
Oh, right? God almighty, what a snaggletooth witch she is, huh? All right, baby, thanks.
Thanks, Donnie.
Christopher Mad Dog Russo here on the Amazon Morning Program. Oh, that's a tennis report.
Yep.
I mean, that's a tennis report, right?
Yeah.
That's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
But why does he yell at
Russo
you?
Russo getting it done.
He, like, yells like it's your fault. I mean, why is he yelling at you for?
Because that's his deal.
That's his shtick. You're jealous. Be quiet.
Yeah, oh, that's his deal.
He got it done, and now you're jealous. You're clapping.
Yes.
Can you let anybody have a spotlight?
Chris Russo just got it done, and what have you done? You know?
Dropped it.
Beat somebody who's been playing chess for a week. You're going to run puffing your chest out. I think I know what a girl's brother. You're a dead man.
Quit school when she was 17. Senator on TV calls her welfare queen. Used to be daddy's little girl. Now she needs help in this mean old world. Buys cassette tapes in the bargain bin. Loves Carlene Carter and Loretta Lynn. Tries to have fun on a Saturday night. Sunday morning don't shine too bright.
Includes 10,000 miles a year, 15 cents for each mile over, $3,500 due at inception. Just add tax, tags, and registration. No security deposit needed.
Ooh, yeah. Betty Curry say I'm pretty sly for a white guy. Just a year ago when I went before the nation, shaking my finger saying I didn't have relations. All the time I'm thinking about that in her panty lace. Who knows Trace how she was sitting on my face. Now since I've been impeached, I'm biting on my lower lip. And I'm hoping that the trial don't end up with a pink slip. Right wing, they try so hard my reputation to malign. But they'll have to drag me out of here because I will not resign. I'm a head of state whose steady day was a piece of jailbait just a little overweight. It was no big deal, could have been concealed till the DNA, the DNA. Give me a break, I know I take the cake. I'm just a white trash Willie who should go on Ricky Lake. The girl got on her knees. Hey, hey, do the taboo thing.
Give it to me, baby.
Well, come and get it. Williams say I'm pretty sly.
Or a white guy.
Back in Arkansas, I had a little chocolate thunder. But did I knock off the whore and sire a little boy, I wonder? There's been so many, can't keep track of all the sex I've had. So it's possible that I could be a deadbeat dad. They can't authenticate who I'm born a cake. Though I'm trying really hard not to give it anyway. A paternity deal could be revealed from the DNA. The DNA. Give me a break, I know I make the cake. I'm just a white trash Willie who should go on Ricky Lake. The world loves dirt and sleaze. Hey, hey, do the taboo thing. But let he without sin cast the very first stone. Cause Larry Flint found quite a few who can't control their throbbing bone. Patronizing politicians with your pompous bombast. You can shove your condescension and then kiss my cracker ass. If you investigate, there is no debate. You in the House and Senate gonna get it anyway. But your pain I feel, so let's make a deal. Cause I won't go away, I won't go away. But give me a break, I know I take the cake. I'm just a white trash Willie who should go on Ricky Lake. The girl got on her knees. The world loves dirt and sleaze. Don't you wish you were me?
Imus in the Morning, and please now welcome to the program, sponsored by a Tri-State Jeep dealer, Fred Imus in the Morning, who's my brother.
Thank you very much for that nice introduction.
You're quite welcome. Where are you this morning?
I'm out at the ranch.
How are things there?
They're going rather well.
You know, we have kids coming.
Yes, I know that.
In April.
In April.
From Atlanta. From the Sunshine Camp. Hamilton Jordan's deal. The Aflac people.
Yeah.
And I saw some pictures of them yesterday. One of them.
And the best ability to handle this particular situation, and that's why I'm picking him to go ahead and win this race.
And, of course, here on the home front, on the Amherst Morning Program, on Monday will be White Trash Monday, in our Jerry Springer version of the Amherst Morning Program, Ricky Lake Monday. And that Chrissy's coming in with her boyfriend, Ted. And Bo's coming in. We're going to send her some.
I don't understand the connection there between...
Bo, what is it? Bo has a hot for Christy. Is that the deal, Bernie?
That is correct.
Oh.
Very hot for Christy. Trying to date her or
right.
Wine and dine her, jet her off to St. Martin, this and that.
Right. She's not having any of it.
From what we understand.
Yeah. As far as we know, although something has happened.
Well, what do you mean by something has happened?
Well, we don't know.
Well, we don't know.
That's what we're going to find out.
So, yeah. But it's my understanding...
Spreading it around a little bit, I wonder.
No, Fred.
Which is not wrong, Ben. Well, I'm not being critical of her, by the way. You know, I'm not criticizing her.
Just
she is doing that. If she is spreading it around,
no.
I'm not being critical.
No,
fine. We're doing
free country. That's just keeping options open.
That just makes her a good woman. You know?
Okay, but anyway, she's very committed.
That thing around, honey.
That will be.
Mm-hmm.
Shut up. She's very committed to this current boyfriend of hers.
Right. Attractive woman, by the way, I might add.
Well, certainly is. But he doesn't need Bo sniffing a chair every time she gets up out of the
right.
bathroom.
Right, doesn't need that. Exactly. And,
I'm going to be watching. I'll tell you, Monday morning, this could be good.
Well, I've given Chrissy the option of not doing this because I respect the fact that Chrissy apparently is very serious about Ted. And we would assume Ted's very serious about Chrissy. And why jeopardize that relationship if it's just...
No, why not?
Well, because we don't want...
We're not hurtful.
I don't want to hurt people.
I mean, she's probably on the lookout for, you know, she's probably going to get a better dealing when she can, you know?
You're not, are you, Christine?
What?
Better deal, Ted.
Better deal, Ted? What?
In other words, if a better deal comes along, if you have to go to another bar and go to the bathroom, and you run into somebody who, you know, you're not looking to better deal, Ted.
Somebody.
Fred.
Yeah.
Are you busy Saturday night?
Oh, yeah.
My brother is married. Aren't you, Fred?
Oh, shucks.
Yeah, but he probably is not lifting. He's probably got the back container running.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. All right. How is a little woman, Fred?
She's doing great, actually.
Well?
Yeah, she's a good woman.
Well?
She's a saint. You kidding me?
I'm like the first one, you know? I've been in enough relationships to know what a nut is, you know?
Yes.
So I actually got a real good one this time.
Well, good.
Separate sleeping bags or what?
No, I stay at the ranch. She stays there.
speaking of nuts, by the way, Lori McNichol, the other woman on the program, she's getting married, you know. And you can't even make this up, Fred. She's marrying somebody by the name of Yusef Habib. Over at the Tavern on the Green in a tent.
Better that than a hangar.
Yes, is he taking a flying lift?
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Or a shoe repair shop. All right. I'll call you later, Fred. Fred?
What?
I'll call you later.
I'm done?
Yes, you're done.
That's it?
Yes, you have nothing. So, it's clear. 21 after the hour.
Hello, darling. Nice to see you. It's been...
Want more excitement this summer? Then get more during the Chrysler Summer Sales Drive, where right now you'll get great deals this season on Chrysler Pacifica. It has the highest 5-star government crash test rating and more. Want more comfort? Pacifica offers room for 6, including 2 rows of fully reclinable seats. Want more direction? It's yours with an available in-dash navigation system. If you need more traction, Pacifica offers available all-wheel drive, designed to take you well beyond the SUV. And now get more value. $1,000 bonus cash for a combined cash allowance of $5,000 for qualified buyers who finance through Chrysler Financial. And of course, Pacifica comes with our exclusive 7-year or 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. Want more of everything summer has to offer? Get to the Chrysler Summer Sales Drive and get more for less today. Not all buyers will qualify. See dealer for a copy of this limited warranty. Transferable to second owner with fee. A deductible applies.
Long distance calls came at 2.
Fred, it's Janice Dean, who is our scum reporter and living up to her name, apparently. And Sid Rosenberg, who is
it's our scum.
Could be the subject of almost every report.
Yeah. Sponsored today, by the way, by Joey Potts and Pants, my little report here with Fred.
Right. Yeah. Well, first of all, good morning, Fred.
Hey, how you doing?
This thing they took out of your neck, Fred, how big? No, it's not funny. How big was it?
Almost the size of a tennis ball.
Wow.
A tennis ball?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you see it?
Yeah, they showed it to me afterwards.
Really?
What did it look like?
A tennis ball.
Well, it looked like...
No, please.
No, I didn't look at it all that close. I just kind of glanced at it, you know?
Yeah. Did you get to keep it, bring it home?
Yeah, they give me a doggy bag.
Excellent.
You should sell it, Autobody Express.
Sell it on eBay.
Yeah.
Fred Imus is goiter. Great. You can sign it and everything.
Tennis with it.
What was it doing? What was it causing you to do?
Put a buffalo on it.
It still hurts.
Oh, it does?
Oh, man. Awful.
That is not good.
Whole side of my face swelled up. I had to go see the doctor this morning.
Oh, shut up, Sid.
Why is
what is funny about this,
Sid? Why is Sid laughing? Well, he's hilarious.
That's why.
Sid. You're going to have a growth on your face, too, soon.
Yeah, look at you.
He does have a growth on his shoulders.
Look at
his head.
He's a raving beauty.
You really are an idiot, Sid.
I feel bad.
No, you don't.
Well, maybe you shouldn't be so quick to sell those pain pills, Fred.
No, and man, you ain't kidding. I'll tell you, you know, I know this isn't funny, but I can see why people get hooked on them.
Really?
They just make you feel better.
Yeah.
I mean, they just kind of mellow you out.
Yeah, they're called painkillers, right?
I obviously been out of the loop for the past 30 years, you know?
Well, how did you do in your football picks?
Well, I didn't do that great. I was 1-3.
That's terrible, actually.
That's awful.
Yeah.
that's not great. That's awful.
The crown jewel would be, of course, me picking Miami to beat Denver in Denver.
That's a great pick.
That would be the crown jewel.
That is a nice pick, but that's the only one that you got right.
And you're exactly right. But that was a great game. It was probably the best game you're going to see all year.
Maybe you were jacked up on pain pills.
That I lost my focus is what happened.
Yeah.
You know?
You're probably not to blame, actually.
No, I'm actually not. I'm probably, instead of taking 4 at a time, I think I'll cut back to like 1 at a time.
You know what you are? In America, you're another victim of drugs.
maybe you should have... Maybe that's what happened when you picked Mark Martin to win that Goody's Headache Tampax 500, whatever the hell it was.
Right.
When he ran 16.
Yep.
These races are really difficult to pick because you got about 20 drivers that can win that race.
Well, you have 43, actually, who start the race.
Yeah, but you got 43, but there's about half of them don't have a chance.
Right.
Well, who the heck is Fred McMurray? No, Jamie McMurray.
Exactly. Who would have picked him?
Yeah.
You would have picked that, you know.
Yeah.
Well, you wouldn't have picked him. you didn't pick him. But then no one else did either. So.
But, I mean, that's just how racing goes. It's, you can, on any given Sunday.
Yeah, but you can't keep picking Bob Elliott and Jeff Gordon for every race. Eventually somebody else is going to win.
You know, it's troubling that Janice Dean from Canada knows the correct name of a NASCAR Goober race driver,
right.
And you don't, Sid.
Probably stalked. Right, just another guy that she's got pinned up on the wall right now.
Hey, come on! Bob Elliott, doesn't he make sausages?
I don't know.
Well, NASCAR is one of the biggest spectator sports going.
Yeah.
Sure.
I've been kicked out of many a room for someone to watch NASCAR.
I mean, they go down there 100,000 people. They think 100,000 people.
Well,
Well, here's a question I have, Janice. What kinds of relationships are you in that somebody is kicking you out of a room to watch anything?
To watch a NASCAR race.
Go shopping. I put the fun in dysfunction.
I'll go shopping. I see. So once he paid you, right, he wants to watch NASCAR, and you got the cash to go out and buy yourself something.
No. I don't think that's what she said.
No.
That's not what she said, is it?
Well, it's just that Sundays are very important for sports fans, and I realize that as a girlfriend. I'm a good girlfriend. Oh. Guys want to be around their TV set and other men while watching these sports.
That's not necessarily true.
No?
When I watch one of these games, I don't want anybody around. I don't want anybody talking. I don't want anybody coming to the door. I don't want anybody calling on the phone. I just want to watch the game.
So males and females included, you want them all out.
I don't want anybody in the house but me. Because I'm there to watch that game. I'm not there to entertain or be entertained by somebody. I'm watching a stinking game, you know?
Yeah, by God.
Just you and your growth.
Just you and your lump there.
And then another thing I watched, you like Bon Jovi?
I love Bon Jovi.
Yeah.
No, I don't like Bon Jovi.
He's great. Bon Jovi's great.
Is he?
They had a free concert, you know, in between the games, the late games and the Sunday night games. So I
sure.
watched that. I
really?
Think I can really sing, you know that?
You like his songs?
Oh, man. He's great.
Could you sing one of his songs? Or?
No, I couldn't sing.
Would you let him watch sports with you?
I might. You know, if he was to bring the whole band.
All right.
You could let your lump watch sports with you. Kind of talk to him like Tom Hanks did in Castaway, you know? Put a little face on him, and that'd be great. Have you named your lump, Fred?
Not yet, but the lump is going to make the picks next week.
Talking with whether it's Carville or whomever, but you work out every single day.
Yeah.
Well, what is your conditioning program consist of?
The dips on his walker.
Lifting that penis.
Hey,
bench pressing my dick.
Shut up. Come on.
That's
now.
Enough.
Hey, Bernard and Charles, did I set myself up for that one?
Yes, yeah. You did.
Well, let me try to see if I can collect myself again, because Bradshaw, he's serious about this conditioning program, and we've got a little bet going. So he calls me up and tells me that he's eating one meal a day.
Yeah.
So I said, Terry, please, what is your meal? You know, he's down on his farm. He says, the best animal to eat is a pig.
Yeah.
I said, you got to be kidding me. So what is your one meal a day? So he's telling me that he's eating roach knuckles, chicken lips. Now, back in the hood, we called it chitlins, but he claims he's eating chitterlings. That's his one meal a day. He asked me about the treadmill. He says, JB, look, this is my first time on a treadmill, and it's got here enter weight. Do I put down my ideal weight or my actual weight? I told him to put down his birth weight. You know?
guess who I had on?
Would you have
on? Go ahead.
Okay.
Are you not done yet?
No, I'm done. Go ahead.
I work out I do 45 minutes on the treadmill.
Okay.
And then I do an hour of weights with a trainer. And you know who my trainer is? A guy by the name of Monty Hunter.
Okay.
Who played briefly for the Dallas Cowboys.
Wow, okay.
And he does not think it's amusing when I tell him that his workouts ain't nothing.
Whoa, means you're in pretty doggone good shape then.
He said, do another 150 crunches then, white boy.
Wow.
Guess who I had on?
Who'd you have on?
Suge Knight.
Hey, you know what? As a matter of fact, I had that as appointment listen yesterday, and I caught some highlights. You really did come very direct with some questions. I did not hear the entire interview, but how did you leave it feeling?
Well, it sure told me. He said, remember this, I am but a phone call away.
Mm-hmm.
He loves me. You know, I'll tell you why. Because I didn't lay off the questions on somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
I asked him. Well, maybe you heard it, but let me just refresh everybody. Who killed Tupac?
I don't know.
Did you kill Biggie Smalls, or did you hire somebody to kill him?
Definitely not. But one thing I would have done, I definitely would have had, eventually had.
And he went on to tell me about it. He would have had Biggie and Tupac on death row. Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
The point was that I didn't try to say, well, you know, people say or they it's been written.
Yeah.
I asked him the question, and he respects that.
You know what, Don, and honestly, on a serious note, as I've listened to you talk with all of your guests, the one thing I really do appreciate and respect about you is that you just call it straight, whatever your feelings are. I mean, I was listening to Carville and Begala, and again, an excellent interview, and as you said, even if you absolutely disagree with Carville, you know the guy calls it straight. He's very honest. He's very loyal. You have to respect him. I thought your questions with Mary Madeline were right on the ball, and she's one of the brightest women that I know as well, very, very sharp lady, whom I don't know her personally, but certainly listening to her and watching her over the years. Quite frankly, there's an issues-oriented program that I do that I host called America's Black Forum, which is kind of a black version of Meet the Press, and essentially it is a mainstream program because we have all the same type of guests as Tim Russert, whom we had on about 2 weeks ago. And I'd like to chat with you at some point about talking about some issues outside of sports as well, because my interests run wider and broader than just sports, but obviously ought to be in a forum that's dedicated for that purpose only.
It's my feeling you don't actually even know anything about sports.
I've been accused of that as well. Matter of fact, I had to get on Bradshaw's case last week because he, well, yeah, I won't air out dirty laundry, but I've been accused of that, but I'm okay with that.
All right, well, here, in case you didn't know, here's who's playing this week.
Hey, but you know where I get all of my information. I get it from Fred. Fred's right on it, you know.
Jets and Raiders.
And I know Fred is picking the Jets. You like the Raiders.
Yeah, 38-7 Raiders.
Wow, Don, that's an awfully big score. I mean, I understand that they've kept Curtis Martin in check when they've gone against him. But my heart is with the Jets. My head says Raiders, but I'm going to go with the Jets.
You know how hard it's going to be for Curtis Martin to gain yardage?
Oh, without a doubt. He's only averaged, well, as a matter of fact, 50 yards the last time, and I think 11 previous to that. So it's going to be awfully difficult. But I'm expecting the Jets, who really are leading the league in giveaway takeaway with plus 17 going into this week, I think they're going to protect the ball very well.
Here's how difficult it's going to be. He's going to feel like he's running, having to carry my penis.
Shut up, man. Oh, almighty.
You know what? Now I know why neither Terry, Howie, nor Chris wanted to do the show this morning. Bernard didn't warn me about that.
Aren't you from Philadelphia?
Say that again?
Aren't you from Philadelphia?
Oh, no, I'm a native Washingtonian, Washington, D.C.
Oh, okay. Well,
but now, in that Tampa Bay Philly game, who do you like?
Eagles, big time.
You like Eagles big time against the Tampa Bay defense?
Yeah.
I understand all the thoughts about how Tampa doesn't play when the weather's cold, but the added incentive here, although I disagreed last week when we were talking about Minnesota and Baltimore because
the motor in the 4.5 points.
Oh, that's a foolish bet.
Two losses.
There.
Go ahead.
Philadelphia 9.5 over the Giants. I'll take the Giants and the 9.5 points.
I like that. It's only 9 points here.
Okay.
All right.
And the Jets over Cincinnati by 4.5. I'll take Cincinnati and the 4.5 points.
Wow. Got one win, maybe. Maybe one win.
Sid, what do you think?
I only like one of his picks. I like the Giants. I think the Jets will cover against the Bengals, and Denver will beat the Chiefs at home and cover. And I think Dallas will lose a tough one in Minnesota and cover as well. So I think he goes 1-3.
Well, we'll find out, won't we?
Yeah, we will, tough guy. And then what's going to happen when it's all said and done and I beat you? What's going to happen? You have not been able to come up with one thing you'll do. One thing. I mean, I did this with Mike Francesa in the college basketball thing. What will you do if I win this tournament?
Nothing. But you know that going in. See, I'm not making any promises. You're going to get nothing.
No.
Racing at Richmond this week. That's the final race, you know, until they go to the 10 race for the shootout.
What?
You're talking about NASCAR now?
Yeah. Kind of made that probably a sloppy transition.
Yeah, it depends how you look at it.
It's sports, and you were talking sports, so sure.
Yeah.
It's fine. What do you like in this race?
I like Casey Kane to win this race, and I like Mark Martin to run in the top five.
How'd you do last time?
I didn't do that good because Gordon blew his engine or something, and he freeze. Was still running, actually, there at Talladega. But he didn't do that well. He didn't finish the race is what happened.
How would that be doing well?
But he's still second in the points, so he's going to go into that 10-race shootout, you know.
Sure.
Jimmy Johnson's leading it.
You should brace him for Hurricane Ivan, huh?
Yeah, well, here's my other pick. I'm predicting that Ivan goes to the left of Cuba.
He's dicking who?
Ivan goes to the left of Cuba and actually goes into the Gulf of Mexico and may hit a little bit of the west coast of Florida. But I'm predicting it won't make a direct hit on Florida.
Based on what? What is your?
Well, I'm watching the tracker. They track it on television.
But they don't have a TV.
Well, I was just kidding. Of course I have a TV. Why would I get a direct TV if I didn't have a TV?
I believed you.
So we all did. Wouldn't be the.
Not sure. He's watching it on his microwave.
Yeah, aluminum foil stuck on it.
Just trying to impress the neighbors. In the trailer park.
Yeah, looks good, doesn't it?
Boy, that Fred must be doing real good.
He's not sleeping on the floor anymore.
It may not even be a real. It may be a skillet out there on a bread.
Wow.
That's great.
What a squirrel stuck to it.
Right. They propped up a hubcap on a brick to tell everybody he's got satellite TV now.
Who's the rabbit ears around?
No. So, are you still on vacation?
Yes, I go back Monday.
Oh, I see.
Oh.
What did they do while you were on vacation?
We just put together...
Celebrated.
We put together some shows, you know, previous shows. And
we call in the hazmat unit.
And run those.
Hose it down.
Well. All right.
My bro.
All right. Always great, Fred.
We have to go.
Well, there's your way to go. On. We got 40 minutes, don't we?
You don't.
We do.
Yeah, we have 40 minutes. We have 28 minutes, actually. 32 after the hour. Okay. Fred Imus, sponsored by his Tri-State Jeep dealer, live from Tucson, Arizona.
How's AOL stock doing? I got 9 shares of it. How's it doing, I wonder?
It sucks.
It does?
Yeah, you need to get on Viacom. I understand that's going to go up.
Really?
Yeah. The opening bell is sponsored by Labenthal. Mark your day, make your day with Labenthal's Bond of the Day. And by your Tri-State Jeep dealer, which also sponsors my brother's hideous appearance. Trail-rated capability only in a Jeep 4x4. The market is, the Dow is open 20 bucks down. NASDAQ's down a buck and change. And that's basically it. So we'll talk to Bud Collins next.
Well, I walked up to the bar. I laid down my platinum card. Then I ordered 50 long necks for my new friends. Well, the barmaid passed them out. And before we shook them down, I held mine up, said, here's to us. And they hung.
Got Florida State, Miami tonight, 8 o'clock Eastern time, on your ABC television network. Old Brent Musburger will be down there doing it. Then you got some tennis all day. You got, and coming up next week on the I Miss the Morning program, Johnny Carson, Michael Eisner, Kofi Annan, Tom Cruise, Condoleezza Rice, Ted Kennedy, and Nicole Brown Simpson. All that just ahead here on the I Miss the Morning program next week.
It's pretty good.
So. Sid, any final sports predictions for you?
Yes.
For me?
Here's what I predict.
Yeah.
That a Russian woman will win the U.S. Open. That is my prediction. Mm-hmm. That the Giants will lose in Philadelphia, and that the Jets will beat the Bengals. That's all I have. That's all I have here for this weekend coming up. And Florida State will beat Miami tonight.
Oh, they will?
Yes. The Seminoles will win tonight. Yeah.
How about my Redskins? How are they going
to
do?
They're going to lose. They're going to lose at home to Tampa Bay.
They are?
Yeah.
That's not good.
Hey, did you watch that show, Joey, last night, by the way? The kid from Friends?
I knew it was
good. No. Yeah, because what's her name was on that show? The Dre DiMaggio from Sopranos.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's her new show.
A little weird. I expected to see Christopher at some point.
Whose live-in boyfriend is Shooter Jennings, the son of the great Waylon Jennings.
Peter Jennings?
The Waylon.
Peter
Jennings. Die.
Do you have the time to listen to me whine?
I miss in the morning.
Take a breath. Summer is all dice for men. Let it take you to a world of pure energy, powerful calm, daring discovery.
I've got you.
Lauder Beyond Paradise for men. Let the adventure begin. Now receive your free sample and register to win the Ultimate Sports Fantasy Sweepstakes. You could win a round trip for two with VIP access to the four major championship sporting events in baseball, football, basketball, and race car driving. Stop by the Estee Lauder counter or the Men's Fragrance Bar at Macy's for details. No purchase necessary. Lauder Beyond Paradise for Men. Now at Macy's.
A good football Friday, everybody. Couple of minutes after 10.
Say it again, Jody. Say it again.
It is a football Friday.
Ah, thank God.
You're on the Mac and Sid Show. I'm Jody McDonald. That makes him Sid Rosenberg. Hello, Sid.
Hi, Jody.
How are you this morning?
Better. Every day is better.
Why?
Well, every day further from the suspension.
They up the meds?
And more meds. You know, it's a cumulative thing with these things. It takes a couple of more days, it works better and better. Yeah. Yeah.
And also the fact that football season is here.
Yeah, we'll do Yang Station.
Also for him.
Oh, okay. Anyway, that's where we are. Charles said there are wind gusts associated with this Hurricane Ivan. Gusts, now it doesn't mean sustained, but gusts of up to 195 miles an hour.
It is a very powerful Category 5, the highest category on the Saffir-Simpson scale.
What causes hurricanes?
Big bad weather.
Okay. So like Wyatt asked me that, that's what I tell him?
Yeah, big bad weather. Coming off the African coast. Big low pressure areas, depression thing. And it comes trundling across the Atlantic.
Why are they only certain times a year?
Because it's got to have heat.
When's it going to hit Florida, is it?
Might hit, now they're saying New Orleans even could be a target for Ivan.
Well, we just went on there on the radio.
Well, other places possibly in the hurricane's path are Mobile Bay, Alabama.
But it'll blow over our transmitter.
The Pensacola, Panama City, Florida area.
The big 1350 in New Orleans.
It looks as though Florida's east coast and extreme southwest are out of the woods, but the storm could still hit anywhere from Tampa Bay north on up north to Panama City to the Panhandle area. And it's projected to clip the western edge of Cuba now, that's next target, before heading toward the Florida Panhandle general vicinity around Wednesday night. And it's a huge storm.
Maybe I should be more concerned about the safety of the people in New Orleans as opposed to, it's going to blow over our stupid transmitter there.
Possibly. And the 65 people who have died so far, and the widespread destruction in the Caribbean, the Grenada and Jamaica and so on.
Fine. Coming up at 8 minutes after the hour here on the
island. 65 dead people. You should be more concerned, and you agreed, and then when he laid it out, you were fine.
Okay, well, I agree.
Well, you're displaying a lot of compassion. For 65 dead Caribbean people.
I'm very sorry about that. It's horrible.
It doesn't sound like it. Very, very dismissive, like you're impatient, bored with the whole thing.
90% of the structures on Grenada damaged or destroyed. 15,000 homes on Jamaica.
Horrible. Well, no, it's horrible. Well, of course, I mean, I know you're trying to make me look bad, but...
No, you're doing a good job yourself.
No, I'm not. I have a program I got to do here. We have to report all the news, and that's part of it.
That certainly
is. You know, he broke off wringing his hands when he's doing the news to you.
No, we're not wringing our hands.
Well, yeah, I mean, just... he does show compassion in his voice when he's talking about dead people, yes.
Sure. Well, so have I. You can see it in his body language, his demeanor.
Well, you can see it in mine, can't you?
No.
You can't?
No. No. It's absent.
Well, you bastards are just misrepresenting what the facts are.
So. Well, let people decide.
9 minutes out the hour, what else going on?
The federal government's decade-old ban on assault weapons soon will be history. The ban, designed to keep military-style weapons out of the hands of civilians, is set to expire today.
You suck, Bernard. I'll tell you good, because I'm going to get me a street sweeper and bring it in here.
Ban on weapons such as street sweepers, Uzis, AK-47s, Tech-9s will have run its course.
Yeah, party.
There you go.
When do the Red Sox and Yankees play? This weekend?
Yep.
That's right, correct, at Yankee Stadium.
Yeah. When's Rosh Hashanah, Thursday?
First day is Thursday, and Rosh Hashanah will be Wednesday night. Thursday and Friday, yes. So, I won't be here on Thursday.
It's not a company holiday. What do you mean you won't be here?
Well, but I'm Jewish, so they gave me one day off. I'm supposed to have 2 days off.
Oh, here we go.
I'm supposed to have 2 days off, but they only gave me one day off.
Well, I asked Julie asked if she could have the day off, and I said, of course.
Both days?
I offer both days.
Really?
And she said she just needed the one day.
Oh, okay.
So?
I'm supposed to get both days, but I'm not allowed to have the second day because I had sex with a black girl once.
So when do you make up this day off that you're going to take?
True story, by the way.
Whoa.
That's true. I'm not recognized in the Jewish religion now as being Jewish enough to have the second day off.
Why don't we all get off?
I don't know.
I don't even know how to respond to that.
But then you wonder
about these columns in the Post.
Right.
And that's why you get them. Because you say stuff like that.
There's another column.
There's another column. I mean, it's just...
I'm in colleague.
It's just...
It's going to be in the Amsterdam News.
You see, I would really be disturbed if I thought you were serious, but you only say that stuff
so
you can get attention.
For shock value.
Which...
Idiot.
At least the message... Maybe I'm rationalizing here, but... At least the message getting out there is not that you're some racist goon, which I don't think you are.
No.
But I just think that, well, obviously you're not racist if you had sex with a black woman.
Just a goon.
Nobody paid for it.
Well, Sid didn't pay for anything. And got slapped in the head by the rabbi.
Dove Kramer,
who is a rabbi. Just came in and slapped Sid.
And how ashamed must he be that Sid is part of his religion?
Oh, God, Dove's going to want to kill himself.
He'll be mortified.
It's the same religion as you.
Here from Tucson, Arizona, with my brother Fred. I'm a sponsor by a Tri-State Jeep. Good morning, Fred.
Hey, man, how you doing?
I'm not doing well.
You know, I tried to call in, but they changed the phone number.
Well, that's a subtle message.
You got through somehow.
Somehow you got through, but...
I did some investigation and was able to get the number.
Right. Did we change the number, Bernie?
We changed the toll-free number.
Oh, I see.
But not the other... Something that Sid might be concerned with, but I wouldn't expect Fred.
Oh, God, look at this.
Oh. Well, sure, hurry up. Oh, hurry up.
She hung up.
Where is she?
Jesus, Mary and Joseph.
Joe Harry, I ran into Joe Harry up in the commissary.
Yeah.
And she has some health problems. You know that?
Yes.
She's all right now, though. She's okay, though.
She cool.
Yeah.
She's a beautiful girl.
She's back.
Joe Harry, what's up?
She's
in the studio punching Sid. Is Joe Harry the black woman you had sex with?
Yes.
Yes.
In your dreams.
When did that happen?
Yeah.
When did he untie you?
Who told me? What black women? That makes you laugh at a Jew?
Oh.
I understand.
You want to sit down?
Yeah.
Well, we can't hear. Well, let her get over
here.
We need both on the air.
Yeah.
Joe Harry, how are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Good.
Walk around a couple of times.
Yeah.
What's that?
What are you upset about now?
I'm sitting at my desk trying to make phone calls and... Sully Iman's show.
Sure.
And I hear this punk over here say, basically allude to the fact that he's less of a Jew because he's had sex with a black woman.
Yeah.
What's that all about?
What is that all about?
Right.
Very good question.
That is...
And then he tried to just glaze over it when you said, what do you mean?
Listen.
Explain yourself.
Don't shoot the messenger. This is just the way it's recognized in certain aspects of certain neighborhoods of the Jewish community. Well, they have Reform, they have Conservative, they have Orthodox, they have different stages of religions, mm-hmm. and some of the Jewish people feel that
so
way.
So this is formalized
yes.
in the Jewish
yes.
religion?
The Jews
no,
are
all Jews are bigots, you say.
It's not in the Torah. It's not in the Torah, but, yeah.
So this is Sid's version.
Not my version. There are people out there that have explained it to me this way.
Okay, so is it only black women? If you had sex with an Asian woman, would it be the same?
No, it's actually good to have sex with an Asian woman.
Hang on, Fred. We'll be back really in a minute, Fred. Don't go anywhere.
Joint rightus, arthritis, pain.
We're to blame them. Coming up on 21 after the hour here on the Amos and the Wayne program, Fred's on the line from Tucson, sponsored by Jeep. How'd you do in your football picks, Fred?
Well, I was 2-2.
Not bad. 500.
Not bad, it's awful.
No, it's not. 2-2 is fine, 50%.
No. If you only pick four games,
right,
you should get them all four right.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's right. Your brother's right, Fred. That's terrible.
I missed the race, too. Casey Kane, the car quit on him, so missed that, too.
What's the matter with Fred's line here? Bernie, are you paying any attention?
It's a little shaky. Maybe it's just Fred.
Yeah. Which games you miss, Fred?
I missed the Kansas City, Denver, and Jets game.
Well, you got to get a different line from
yeah,
Fred.
Ain't working.
That's crazy. All right, here's Sid. We'll try to reconnect with Fred.
Yeah.
Here's Sid.
All right, man. He just talked about it. Denver beat Kansas City last night, 34-24, one of the more exciting games of the day. But the good news is Joe Gibbs back in the NFL, and the Washington Redskins win yesterday. Beat Tampa Bay 16-10. Clinton Portis had a huge day for the Redskins. Jets beat the Bengals yesterday, 31-24. Curtis Martin had a huge day as well, 196 yards on the ground. The
wow.
Eagles beat the Giants yesterday. How about Dante Culpepper for the Vikings yesterday? They beat Dallas 35-17. Culpepper threw five touchdown passes in the win. And the old man actually did pretty well. Vinny Testaverde threw for 355 yards for Dallas in the loss. He actually did play well. Terrell Owens, by the way, I forgot to mention, an Eagles win over the Giants, had three touchdown catches in his debut as a Philadelphia Eagle. So all that in the NFL yesterday. Baseball yesterday. Yep, go ahead.
Went to other games?
Yeah, what game are you interested in?
Browns-Ravens.
Browns-Ravens, 20-3. Cleveland beat Baltimore yesterday.
How'd that happen?
Here's how it happened. The Ravens have a young quarterback, Kyle Bowler, who's not really very good yet. And the Ravens can only score if Jamal Lewis can run the football. And the Browns concentrated on shutting down Jamal Lewis. They were able to do it. And at the end of the day, the Ravens had no offense.
What Tim Couch do for the Browns?
Yeah, he doesn't play. He doesn't play in the Browns anymore. No.
Where does he play?
Well, he actually got cut by the Green Bay Packers about 2 weeks ago, so I don't believe he's playing anywhere right now. The quarterback for the Cleveland Browns is a guy named Jeff Garcia, who you may remember was involved in a controversy a couple of weeks ago, because Garcia used to be the quarterback with the San Francisco 49ers.
Right.
And when his former teammate, Terrell Owens, now on the Eagles, was asked whether or not Jeff Garcia is a homosexual, he said, if it looks like a rat and smells like a rat, must be a rat.
You meant duck.
Or duck, right?
Yeah, the saying
that's
is,
right.
If it quacks like a duck,
right.
Waddles
yeah.
like
yeah.
a duck.
But we
yeah.
were feeling him, though. We
yeah.
feel him.
Well, you know what T.O. was trying to say.
Fred's back.
He is? Yeah.
So, Fred.
Yes, how's my connection now?
Much better. What games do you miss now?
I missed the Kansas City-Denver game and a Jets game.
Well, you won the Jets game, didn't you? Oh, you had the Bengals?
Yeah, I took the Bengals.
Oh, yeah.
Which games did you get correct?
I got the Washington game and the Dallas game.
California. The Vikings, good job.
Was that a good job?
It was a good pick, the Vikings.
Well, because, I mean, they were favored by 9.5 points, I think.
Yeah.
Who?
They covered that.
The Vikings.
No, they're favored by 4, actually. But you're close. 9.5, 4. Close. You're right there.
What else?
No, hey, put it. No.
What?
Oh, that damn dog, you know, he's in the truck. And then people walk their dogs by the truck.
Mm-hmm.
And he thinks he has to bark at every one of them that walks by.
Gee,
you
imagine...
understand, no? Hello?
Apparently not.
What?
Imagine a dog doing that. Yeah. Barking at another dog. That never happens.
I don't know. I'm right. My trailer's right on the path where people walk their dogs, you know?
Sure.
And then after, they haven't learned just to go another route, you know?
Well, why should they have to?
Because my dog's in the truck and he doesn't like it.
Jimmy. Oh, that's perfectly understandable, then. Fred is the worst kind of dog owner.
No, I'm the best. I am. God, this dog's got it made.
God.
Typical of a pit bull owner or...
Yeah, exactly.
Rottweiler.
Oh, they're fine.
Yeah, don't worry. It's okay. He just wants to sniff your crotch a little bit. That's all right. He won't bite.
Yeah, he loves little children to eat. Exactly.
Got that 10-race shootout with NASCAR coming up.
Well, what?
The 10-race shootout, you know, the 10-race, 10-team shootout.
Who are the drivers in the 10-race shootout?
Oh, boy. Okay, Jeremy Mayfield, Mark Martin.
Hang on. Yeah.
Jeff Gordon.
Yep.
Jimmy Johnson.
Yep.
How many is that? Is that 10?
It's 4.
So Mark Martin, Jeremy Mayfield.
Well, you just said that.
Jimmy Johnson. Well, I have to repeat because I'm Jimmy Johnson, Gordon. Kenseth in there?
Yes.
That's 5.
Dale Earnhardt Jr., Tony Stewart,
yeah.
Elliot Sadler.
Yeah.
Kurt Busch.
Yeah.
And Ryan Newman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I could have looked up, you know, I got my computer hooked up to the,
Sure.
To the cable. You know, they say it makes it much faster.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the guy came out and did it, and I said, you know, then you get a different, you know, it's a different, it's Cox.net now instead of AOL, but I said I want to keep my AOL, so could you, you know, when the computer turns on, make sure the AOL comes up first.
Yeah.
Well, something happened. I don't know what happened, but I can't even sign on to AOL, and I don't know how to get to the other cable.
Right.
I guess I didn't pay attention enough when he was telling me how to do it.
Right.
So now I just can't get on at all. If I wanted to get on, I have to go back to the telephone line.
Right.
So at this point, it just did me no good.
It's a complete loss.
Complete loss, you know.
Maybe you should call the guy.
I am going to call him. Probably too early now, but... This seems like a simple thing, don't it?
Well, yes, it does.
I can't get anything now. I have to buy a newspaper to find out what's going on now.
Right. What are you liking tonight's game?
Well, I'm a big Brett Favre fan, so I can't hardly pick against Green Bay.
Ooh, that's a tough one. On the road at Carolina, I agree with Nance. I think the Panthers win tonight.
Yeah, yeah, Panthers are, yeah, I know they're a good team. Yeah. How about them Browns, huh?
Hey, how about them?
How about Kellen Winslow? Hey, how about Arizona and
St. Louis?
St. Louis, you know, Arizona, I mean, they haven't had a good team. I don't think since they've been in Arizona.
Yeah.
But, man, this is a different team now, even though they lost yesterday.
They lost.
They lost, but you can see this team is on the way.
Yeah.
On the way to what?
Yeah, I didn't see it.
On the way to start winning some games.
Yeah.
On the way to another loss?
No, I mean, but they're going to start winning. Well, this is a different, a whole different team than it was.
Yeah, but they lost.
But it's the way they lost, right, Fred?
Yeah, but a lot of people are going to lose to St. Louis because of all the weapons St. Louis has.
There you go.
Did you watch it? Did you watch the St. Louis-Arizona game?
I watched quite a bit of it, yeah.
Hmm.
I just really, I don't know.
Impressive.
Do you have anything else?
In their loss.
How much time do I have to come up with something?
Well, no, if you don't already have it,
that
answers our question.
Would it be a no?
Just it would be a no against 28 up there.
Andre Davis wide to the right, Aaron Shea into the game at tight end, tight right side, Winslow tight left side, Morgan wide left, Jackson a running back, here's Garcia back, he does have time, he's going to throw, he's got Morgan wide open, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown!
Boys upstairs this
the world on a string, and I'm sitting on a rainbow.
If this is... bucks.
All right. NASDAQ's up $7 as well. Crude oil is up 82 cents. It's at $43.63 a barrel. So, I was talking to my wife. I said, I have to go home and change my jeans, my Wranglers, because the pair I have on, the knees, they must be 10 years old, and the knees ripped out in them. And, you know, I should really wear a more respectable. I mean, that's all I have are Wranglers.
Right.
So, and sometimes I wear Levi 517s, but I'm really committed to Wranglers. But I have to change them before I go to Washington, D.C., because I'm going to have a pair of torn jeans that look like Dwight Yoakam. I just don't need to do that. So I was saying to my, Charles, my wife is, she just is a great person. She just, I love her to death, and plus I like her.
You were saying?
Plus she's a great, she does great work, and she's a great role model for her.
You were saying she's the best there is.
She really is for these kids. She's a great, you know, it's good for these girls to come out to the ranch and see somebody who can ride a horse like a man, who can rope, who can hike up the 7,000 foot altitude mesa, who can do everything, and who also runs the ranch. Mm-hmm. So, and she's a great role model for them. But the problem sometimes is...
There is a problem?
Well, when she's in a bad mood, because she never says she's in a bad mood. She won't own up to it. She's just, you know, we all get cranky.
She's a trooper, in other words.
So she gets enormously irritated at things I do. For example, she'll try to tell me something, and if I'm playing chess or if I'm whatever, mm-hmm. and I don't act as though I'm paying attention, well, I mean, it's just, but she does and that's just one example, but she does almost all, we're very similar people, born about 2 weeks apart, and not years, but a month. But she does, so the things that I do, which is often the case with people, the things in others that really irritate us, we're guilty of ourselves.
Damn, I'm going to write that down.
And so, and the mistake I make is, like, I'll try to tell her something, and it's just clear she's not listening.
Yeah.
She doesn't pay any attention because she's not interested, which, by the way, is fine. Usually it's just nonsense anyway. So, and the mistake I make is pointing it out to her.
Because the inconsistency.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Because then
that could be a mistake.
Then it just sounds like I'm bitching at her.
Yeah.
Which is what it is.
Yes.
So my goal now is to not do that. So. Anyway,
what?
Jesus.
Hello, Mr. Marshall speaking.
Hello.
Hi, ma'am. How are you?
Is hi, Maria?
Que pasa?
Is Jimmy there?
Is who here?
Hi, Jimmy.
No, he's not. Who is?
Do I have the right number?
Yes, you do. Who are you calling?
I'm calling Paco or Jamie.
Paco or Jamie?
Any of them, my son.
No, ma'am, you don't have the right number. They're not here.
Okay.
So hang up and call the right number.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, fine. Well, I don't want to jerk the lady around about her kids.
Of course not.
Here's Dennis the Puerto Rican. Morning, Dennis.
Could be one of her kids.
Yeah, Dennis. What do you want?
What up, dog?
You're a dog. My new favorite group, Terror Squad. Hip to him?
I think he's,
he's gone.
He's gone.
22 yeah. Till they are here, aren't they?
Steal a better cell phone, will you?
Honest to God, what is that all about? I mean, we don't need it, do we? The Cox Classic, this is...
Oh, my God.
This big golf tournament's coming up on September 20th out at Fiddler's Elbow Country Club in New Jersey. And there will be 800 golfers playing on 7 golf courses. And the IMUS Teed-Off Challenge, in which Charles and I are scheduled to play, well, are going to play.
Sure.
Mike and a Mad Dog. In one or two or three holes or something.
Yep.
And that's for a bunch of money from AT&T. And then they have a little dinner that night, and Deidre Imus is going to speak, in which Charles worked on her speech for 2 days last week. Mm-hmm. So it could be good. And she'll tell us all about it. I don't know. Well, it's good.
It's her work.
Her work, yeah.
Yes.
And, of course, it raises money for the Imus Ranch, the Tomorrow's Children's Fund, and the CJ Foundation for SIDS. I'd like to thank the people from Mercedes-Benz for contributing a car. I doubt that it's an S600, but... So... But they've contributed a Mercedes-Benz.
They've contributed a Mercedes-Benz. Contributed.
But you can get them for 25 grand.
It's a fine automobile for whatever. They've contributed a Mercedes-Benz.
It's not like they stepped up.
Oh, Jesus. What did they do?
They should have contributed a S600 sport deal with a sport package on it. But they didn't, did they?
No, they didn't.
No. So they're going to raffle off 1,500 tickets at 100 bucks a ticket. And then you can win the car. So there's some corporate sponsorships available. We'll broadcast it on WFAN in New York. And then y'all watching MSNBC, we'll be able to see some tape of it the next day when Charles and I crush Fatso and Fruit Loops.
Absolutely. Humiliate.
Yeah. Beat him like a red-headed mule.
Sure.
So. Sid Rosenberg's in the studio and continues to humiliate himself and, by extension, our program.
And annoy the larger metropolitan area, apparently, judging from emails received today.
Well, I'm just telling you like I heard it as a kid, so. Could be wrong. Could be one of those urban legends, you know. But in Brooklyn, that's what they tell you. So, I apologize if I offended anybody, but that's what I was told.
Well, I was told a lot of things, you know.
Yeah.
Growing up,
Were you told what I said earlier today?
No.
No.
I never told that.
Yeah.
But are you saying that's part of the Jewish religion?
I'm not saying it's part of the religion. I'm saying that it's not in the Torah. I mean, people like Dove don't go by those rules, but there are certain people of the Jewish faith that...
Who are bigoted.
Who are racist.
Racist.
Well, I wouldn't say that. You know, it's... You know,
well, how would you describe it?
Well, it's because a Jewish person is supposed to marry a Jewish person. That's just the way it is, so... That's, you know, that's just the way it works. I don't think that makes you bigoted. I think Italian people want to marry Italian people, and Asian people want to marry Asian people, and so on. It's fine.
Right.
That's deeply embedded in your culture and religion.
See, I'm anything but bigoted because I have friends, and I've been with women from all kinds of...
Don't want to know who you've been with.
Yeah, it's stupid. Anyone cares.
No, it's disgusting.
Yeah. But you can't call me a bigot because, you know, it doesn't matter to me. Asian, Puerto Rican, I don't care. Black.
You're a multiculturalist.
Yeah.
Sure.
I'm like Tiger Woods.
You really are, huh? Senator Kerry's going to be on Wednesday.
Yep. Big deal. He's a wimp.
Well?
He really is. He's an embarrassment. His daughters are cute, though. And, you know, by the way, his ex-wife had cancer treatment, and the news is she's okay, which is nice. And his daughters were by her side, and there was no trace of John Kerry. So that says to me, I got Teresa now, I got all the money. He can care less if his ex-wife just dropped dead. he could care less. I'm serious. He never showed up once.
You know what I know?
What?
I know you are serious.
No, I'm dead serious.
That's troubling.
Dead serious. He could care less. What's her name? What's this broad's name? His ex?
No,
Julia Thorne. Julia Thorne.
Yeah.
Care less if she dropped dead.
Well, maybe she doesn't want to see him.
Yeah, but...
It's fairly acrimonious, you know, from the gossip that he was stepping out.
Yeah, but he should still show some interest. I mean, she's on the cancer treatment. She's the mother of his two daughters. I mean, don't you think he should show some type
of... Well, if you're not welcome, though, you're not welcome.
I barged the door down just to show my daughters that I still cared. But I have soul. And obviously John Kerry doesn't.
Don't look at me. Don't look at me.
I'm just saying.
He's your shameless, fameless sidekick.
He's not my sidkick.
That's
he's,
the headline.
Some schmuck that works
paper.
On a program. And a long line of them, by the way. Holy God.
Barry Bonds, 699 career home runs.
That's just great. Let's check with an update on what's going on in the world. Good morning, Charles.
Good morning, I-Man. There are unconfirmed reports of at least two deaths on Grand Cayman now, the largest of the three Cayman Islands comprising the British territory. Grand Cayman hit by Hurricane Ivan's winds and storm surge. Within the past several hours, people stood on rooftops. In fact, there's a report that water was so high, a car floated by a second story of a building. Since then, Ivan has strengthened further to a Category 5 storm headed for Cuba's western tip.
Decision is expected today on whether to order evacuations along the Florida Panhandle, which is a possible hurricane target. People chased from the Keys by fears of Ivan were told today that evacuation orders have been lifted, as southern Florida apparently is going to be spared. The U.S. military suggests it made a successful strike on a gathering of insurgents in Fallujah, Iraq. Would not disclose details as yet, but at least 16 people dead, 12 wounded. Congressional inaction results in a ban on assault weapons expiring today. Big guns legal again. Hearing is set for this morning on U.S. Airways bankruptcy protection. Carrier has been facing mounting debts in a restive pilots union. And North Korea has granted approval for Western diplomats to go in and tour the site of this massive explosion we've heard about the past several days. Last week's blast in a remote northern area near the border with China sparked fears of a possible nuclear weapons test that was fiercely disputed by officials from both South Korea and the U.S., who say despite the blast and subsequent mushroom-like cloud, the incident lacks the key signature signs of a nuclear test, and the North Koreans reportedly are saying it was for a hydroelectric project.
15 till the hour here in the I'm Mr. Mine program. You know, and the other local baseball news is that apparently the manager of the New York Mets, Art Howe, has been fired.
No, he hasn't been fired yet. He will be fired at the end of the year.
So he knows that. The team knows that. The team is 2-19, and for some, recently in the last 21 games, and for some inexplicable reason, they're actually going to play a doubleheader today.
Yes.
Which is troubling.
Well, they got games to play, and they've got people show up at the stadium. They're still going to make a couple of bucks before the end of the year, but Art Howe is, in fact, on his way out.
And who would they get next, then?
The hot rumors are they are going to get Lou Piniella from Tampa Bay. Now, remember, 2 years ago when they fired Bobby Valentine, Piniella was their first choice when he was managing in Seattle. But Seattle wanted some of the Mets' better young players, and the Mets were not willing to part with those guys back then. By the way, since then, the Mets have traded those players, ironically enough. But now, once again, another firing by the Mets coming up, and once again, Lou Piniella is the number one man on the hit list. And they'll get him this time, I believe.
Why would he live in Tampa Bay? Why would he leave there to come here?
Because he's a winner. You know, all those great teams with the Yankees, even managing Seattle, did a good job. Won a World Series managing Cincinnati back in 1990. And this is a terrible Tampa Bay team that's going nowhere.
How did he do in Seattle?
Did well. And they didn't win World Championships, but at least they're in the playoffs every year. They had Randy Johnson, Ken Griffey, Alex Rodriguez. Mm-hmm. This Tampa Bay team stinks, and I think Lou Piniella wants a shot to win again. With that said, I don't know why he'd come to the Mets, but I think he thinks that he could probably restore something here in New York, and I think he'll be the next manager of the New York Mets.
Right. Where does that Art go?
Cares. I don't know.
Wasn't he a nice guy?
He goes back to Florida in a different capacity, like Lou Piniella.
Yeah, that's it. Shuffleboard and bingo and...
Dog track,
you got it.
Well, yeah. All right, 13 till the hour.
Coors Light isn't just a great beer. It's a beer that acknowledges real greatness only comes to those who achieve really great things.
I have subjected myself to quadruple bypass surgery just to avoid going on vacation with my wife.
I have had sex with three generations of the Barrymore family.
I have a lockbox.
I have done blow at my old man's vacation home because I could.
I have absolutely no chance at being elected President of the United States.
Great achievements deserve a great beer. Unleash the all-American taste of Spur's Light.
I have to cut one. Pull my finger.
Drink responsibly. Partisan Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Seymour Hersh couldn't believe when I, even though I said I was not going to put him on, that I wouldn't put him on. He calls anyway. And what that reveals is that he doesn't think, either he doesn't mean what he says, or he doesn't think anybody else does. The same with that snarly little bridge troll agent of mine, Lobster Newberg, that wretched little beast. They think that, I mean, it's disgraceful the way these people behave. They are disingenuous lying weasels, and they'll say anything to try to jerk you. I mean, it's absurd. I mean what I say.
Yeah, but
same with Scranton, same with the Seymour Hersh. Same with that hairy little bridge troll over there at ICM.
But
well, hung up on me.
But I mean, you got great listeners there, Scranton. They love you. Well, people love you there. I mean,
it's not their fault.
You've got like the grassroots of Pennsylvania that's in back of you there. And I think you should give them an opportunity. Hey, people can make amends. I made some mistakes. You've forgiven me over the last 18 years. But I try to learn from my mistakes. And people can always change.
Yeah, oh, sure.
You know, I got that Mediterranean disease. The thing with the blood, I told you.
So Why don't you go get checked up now so we can you've been on for an hour.
But you love me? I miss you.
Of course I
get
I
up
that.
At 4 o'clock this
I know,
morning.
But
I put this
time
pink
to leave.
Tie on.
It's
and
time.
I'm here with you. I love you.
I love you.
I'm waiting
now
for
now it's time to go.
Can't you talk about...
But as we were just...
But then the cops came home to go back inside.
Oh, there was a curfew.
What? Yeah.
You really are just... You're a subhuman. You're just... You're beyond a disgrace.
Love this, Dave Evans.
Joint Ritis Arthritis Pain Relief Ointment. Now let's find out from Dorothy Fryer of Pennsylvania how it's helped.
People are repulsed by you. No wonder the Phil Mushnicks of the world and other people. No wonder.
I mean, your computer smokes from the emails pouring in every
day. I'm no big fan of Mushnick, but he's absolutely right.
Jeez.
I mean, you're repulsive.
But you know what I'm saying.
No, I don't know what you're saying.
Well, Bunny knew what I was saying.
Well, I know what you're saying. Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Yeah.
But is there any validity to it? No.
Well, Bunny, is there validity to it?
There are some gay stewards, and they do a fantastic job,
what?
As I said.
Exactly.
And some of them are cuter than the stewardesses. So you were wrong on that point. They, that's a plus.
Well, all right, then I apologize. I stand corrected. I'm sorry.
Well, but they were all polite and
efficient and...
They're like butlers in the air. They're incredible.
Unbelievable.
But then you killed it because you took the good sandwiches off the plane, remember? And you put that...
No, yesterday we had tuna sandwiches.
Oh, you
on the way
did?
Down. Yes, I
did. See, last time you screwed us, you put that alfalfa and like the, was horrible. Remember that?
Here's the thing. My wife agrees. She's not like a nitwit. You guys want to eat that stuff? It's fine.
I can't eat that.
It's probably not going to kill you. You know, if a steady diet of it might, but something's going to kill you anyway. It'll be something. It's just, if it makes you feel well, like Bernard took home a whole... Bernard had him pack all the sandwiches on board.
I
did it was unbelievable. It was embarrassing.
No, wait a second. I took tuna. I asked him for two tuna fish there. I ate like a rabbit. I ate a salad.
Hey, let me ask you this. How about stopping at Wild Oats or wherever else you want to go?
Because I wanted to eat the tuna sandwiches, but I didn't want to do it right then because it would have
had Bernard has them.
Made me tired.
Has the flight attendant. Packing stuff, packing them a lot.
I asked him for two. And you said, take the whole bowl. And I said, I don't want the whole bowl.
I didn't say anything.
You
I was mortified.
No.
A little doggy bag. I was so embarrassed.
She gave me two nice...
Shocking.
In fact, I was going to bring one in for Sid this morning because I know how much he loves
it. I do. That tuna fish, for some reason, on that plane.
That's right.
It is good.
Thank you.
Right, isn't it? Yeah. It's great.
Yeah.
And I had none
on the plane, and I wanted to enjoy it later on.
But you didn't bring one in for me today.
No, I ate all three.
Oh.
Sorry.
Three.
I got something you can eat, though, sir.
That's a vicious lie. It's 28 after the hour.
It's organic.
Here on the Iverson Morning Program.
Ah, full of protein.
That's like my grandmother. She would go down to restaurants in South Florida with, like, a shopping bag, and she would take out rolls and sweet and low.
No, it's not the same
salt
thing.
Salt and pepper shaker.
Don't compare me to you.
I go to...
Your grandmother would steal stuff, Jay? You're kidding. In your family? You're not serious, are you? Your grandmother.
Well, wait a second. Every grandmother does that. Every grandmother does that.
Yeah.
Every grandmother.
That's what I remember about my grandmother.
Yeah, right? Am I right?
Petty theft.
What? Come
every,
on.
Every grandmother does
yes.
that?
Yes. Every...
Wyatt's grandmother doesn't do that. Mary Ann.
How do you know? You ever walk in the house and go, oh, that's a nice salt and pepper shaker. Where'd you get that from? And she thought, she took it off of, some...
Oh, shut.
Oh, okay.
Shut up.
All right. Okay.
You are just a criminal.
No, because you don't live in the real world.
No, old school grandmas,
Every grandma steals from restaurants, whether it's sweet low or rolls. I'm serious.
Yeah, but unlike yours, they don't try to beat the check on top of it.
Spoor's Light isn't just a great beer. It's a beer that acknowledges real greatness only comes to those who achieve really great things.
I have cheated on my wife with an ugly fat chick. I have condemned people for being addicted to illegal drugs, when all the while I was paying my housekeeper to buy me illegal drugs.
I have read the Constitution of the United States and only moved my lips a few times.
I have publicly declared my admiration for Adolf Hitler. I have privately declared my admiration for Adolf Hitler.
I have no idea who Adolf Hitler is.
Great achievements deserve a great beer. Unleash the all-American taste of Spoor's Light.
I have fondled the woman's breasts without first obtaining her permission.
Hey, what do you know? So have I.
Drink responsibly. Partisan Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Welcome back to the Friendly Carp.
I'm fine, baby. How are you?
I'm hanging in there.
So.
Listen, babe, we all have to admit, that Sid pretty much does talk for the average man a little bit better than you. You have a tendency to get up on your little high horse a little bit and try to look down on him because, let's take, for instance, his grandmother. Think about his grandmother.
No.
Now, that doesn't make her a bad woman. It's just the way the mentality of the Depression-era people. If you can glom something, you glom it. You just take it, and you never know when you're going to need that stuff. And in a lot of little instances, Sid, he's a bad guy, I admit that. But he speaks the truth. You really got to admit that.
You're advocating his grandmother stealing salt shaker from Denny's.
If she can get away with it, yes.
So you're embracing larceny.
Yes, a better way to put it.
Come on, Chuck, you too. You're chiming in, too. You two guys who never had a lap dance. Who are you kidding, man? You're trying to tell me you can speak for the common man?
I don't think it makes you a common man because you haven't had I'm not a common man because you haven't had some pig give you a lap dance.
Well, how about some pig come over as a call girl? Will you ever try that, Linus?
Well, I don't know. I can't answer that question.
That's your business.
No, I mean you're a crazy person.
I got your number though, don't I?
No, you don't have my number.
Come
first
here,
of all,
I'm gonna kiss you in your little skinny way.
I don't need a black man calling up scaring me. Get off my phone. And get your own phone too, by the way. 22 chilly hour.
There it is.
Oh, that's a funny brother.
Yeah.
Huh? 22. 22 till they are here on the Iverson Morning Program. Well, Yankees Red Sox this weekend. There's a kid. Oh God, a corporal. Remember him? That Walter Reed just had the Red Sox T-shirt on.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, you were great yesterday, Barney. You both were. You guys were great.
I would have been great too if you would have taken me.
No, you wouldn't. You'd have been horrible.
Oh, that's an embarrassment,
please. But Charles and Bernard were really good.
These guys, the courage
that these guys display.
No, it's shocking almost.
Stunning. An honor. And thank you for inviting us.
How many guys do you think throughout the day did you see? I mean, how many soldiers did you see before you left?
35, 40.
Dozens.
Dozens, probably a lot.
What's it to you? What are you interrogating about?
No, I think it's just a very honorable thing you guys did. I actually was upset.
It wasn't any honorable thing we did at all.
Sure.
Senator McCain asked me to come down, and I said I would. And I invited Charles and Bernard.
It was an honor to be in
these guys'
presence.
Invited and to be in Senator McCain's presence. And,
and these kids.
And these kids. And we met Nora O'Donnell's mom. What a nice lady she is, huh?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh, she's doing it.
She volunteers.
Oh, at the hospital?
Yeah.
She services some of the soldiers.
Yeah. Is she cute? What's she look like? Is she like Nora?
Well, she's a little older.
Well, like, does she look like Rosie O'Donnell or Nora O'Donnell?
No, she's a nice-looking woman.
Yeah.
Oh, no, she's a very kind of a sophisticated,
kind of elegant, too,
elegant
lady,
woman.
Yes.
Very nice.
She's a volunteer. That's what she is.
That is nice.
Good lady.
Yeah, lovely woman. Yeah. She doesn't have to be over there doing that.
No.
But she is.
See, not like your grandmother going around stealing
stuff. You're taking James' grandmother going down there stealing stuff.
It's unbelievable that you got... Lou is the only person that can help me.
I can see her. Already helped you with it.
My grandmother's in Rikers lots of times.
See, since grandmother going to Walter Reed, she's walking out with catheters and with stuff.
A peg leg and whatnot.
Yeah.
Look what I got.
I still say that most
of... rolls of bandages and rubber gloves. And
whatever you can get your hands on.
Jacket full of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Social Security, you know, these poor people live down in Florida. They got set incomes.
A vial of OxyContin, some poor guy
no kidding.
Screaming in pain.
What do you think I learned how to pay for one movie and see the second one for free?
I'm sure.
And down in Florida, they're like 50 cents for these elderly people, too. It doesn't matter.
At grandma's knee.
It's in the jeans. Well,
wasn't your grandmother executed for treason?
No, that wasn't my grandmother, idiot. But I think she was related to me in some...
Right. Of course, in some way she was.
She fell out of a guard tower, I think.
The opening bell of the New York Stock Exchange is sponsored by Labenthal. Make your day with Labenthal's Bond of the Day. Labenthal, pretty good outfit, you know? Not going to jerk your chain and lose your money for you. So, also sponsored by your Tri-State Jeep dealer. Trail-rated capability, only in a Jeep 4x4. The market has been open. I'm coming up on 12 minutes, and the Dow is up 65. No, it's crude oil.
It is.
The NASDAQ is up 18. The Dow is up 3 and change, so not a big deal. What else going on? What else in sports? So anyway, it's all the kids. So we're talking to him about the Red Sox-Yankees series this weekend.
Yeah. He's a Red Sox fan.
Yankees were blown out by Kansas City last night.
Right.
So the spread now is 3 games.
Correct.
And if it stays that...
The Red Sox, if they can sweep the Yankees this weekend, will be tied for first next week.
Right.
Yeah.
Do it for that kid in the gurney that we saw. Put a smile on his face.
What I said, there was another kid behind him in a gurney who was a Yankee fan.
They have too many rings already.
Oh, okay. All right. Fair enough.
Do it for this one poor kid.
It could happen. That Yankee pitching staff is just miserable. Last night, they were terrible. This is Kansas City that scored 17 times.
The Red Sox don't really have anybody, do they?
Kurt Schilling?
Pitchers?
Pedro Martinez? Yeah.
Darn.
Oh, Pedro sucks.
Pedro sucks? You know what Pedro's record is right now?
We'll see when the playoffs come.
Okay, we'll see. He's pitching tonight, actually, against Scott Kazman.
He folded last year.
Huh?
Okay. He didn't fold.
That idiot manager left him in the game for too long, and he got fired for it.
Sucked in that game.
Okay. Yeah. We'll see what happens this year.
Yeah, let's hope.
Okay. Who scheduled a pitch in the Bronx for the Red Sox?
I believe it's...
Do you know?
Schilling, Lowe, Martinez.
Well, let me find out that that's wrong.
The three pitchers I can think of.
You are such a... does Mako know? Any of those...
Here comes Lou Piccolo.
Sure. Any of those...
Any second now.
Any idiots out in the newsroom
Absolutely.
Have any idea?
Of course they know.
Well, they'll know now. They'll get it. And they'll come
right
away.
And they all look like geniuses. They all look it up. You put me on the spot all the time. You know, it's 5 days from now. I don't know, you know. I don't know the whole rotation by heart.
Well, you would think it was one of the more significant baseball
series
in this year or any year.
You're right. No, I should know.
You think you would know that?
Yeah, I don't know it.
Well, we know.
I'll tell you who would know. Mike Francesa. What?
It doesn't stop with you. You're unbelievable.
Do you know that they don't know out there? Excuse me. I'm sorry, fan.
They don't know.
Nobody knows.
Yeah.
In the WFAN newsroom, bullpen, whatever they call this stupid thing.
Right. Some of the great sports minds in the country.
just a couple of feet away from us. They have no idea.
The premier sports radio station in America.
Right, in the world.
And these nitwits out there.
They're all scrambling on a computer trying to look it up.
Really? What else going on?
On the fan.
The Packers beat the Panthers last night. Pretty impressive effort. Here's Jody McDonald, my partner from 10 to 1. He's got your answer for you.
Okay. Sure, he just looked it up.
Well.
Good morning, Jody.
How are you, man?
Fine, baby. How are you?
It's funny. I just figured this out for myself 15 minutes ago, so we'd be prepared for the Mac and Sid show today.
Sure.
Or at least one of us would be prepared
for
that.
That would be you, yes.
Yes. Bronson Arroyo against El Duque on Friday night.
Told you.
Saturday is Derek Lowe against John Lieber.
Had that.
And Sunday is Pedro Martinez against Mike Messina.
So what are you busting my chops for? Exactly what I told you.
Messina.
Bronson Arroyo, he didn't
I hate to see him get on the mound. God, what a disaster.
Terrible. He's just terrible.
How's it sound to you?
I think it'll be a good weekend series. I actually think Yankees have the pitching edge. They get lucky that they miss Schilling. Schilling pitches Thursday night, so the Yankees don't have to face their best pitcher.
Told you.
There you go. You told us. You didn't say anything. You didn't know.
I told you that it was going to be Arroyo.
That's not what you said.
No. Derek
Wakefield.
You said Schilling, Lowe, Martinez.
That's Lowe.
You idiot.
Wakefield is not pitching in the upcoming series.
Well. All right, well.
Two out of three.
Well, ask me something else. Come on, tough guy. Let's have it.
Hey, A-Rod's only batting, what, 300?
The lineup.
John is in a basement mixing up the medicine. I'm on a pavement thinking about the government. A man in a trench coat, batch out laid off. Says he's got a bad cough, wants to get it paid off. Look out, kid. Something you did, God knows when, but you're doing it again. You better duck down the alleyway, looking for a new friend. A man in a coonskin cap in a pig pen wants $11 bills. You only got 10.
I miss in the morning.
When you face a serious medical issue, where do you go?
Motor Trend said they had driven few other coupes so poised, so well-balanced, so confidence-inspiring. End quote. Get the full story at GTO.com. With Smart by Financing, get a GTO for around $299 a month for 35 months with $1170 down after GMAC bonus. Tax, title, license, and dealer fees extra. $18,586, 36-month payment, 3.5% APR. This example is for qualified buyers. Your payments may vary. Residency restrictions apply. Call 1-800-2-PONTIAC for details. See your local Pontiac dealer today.
Hey, fans, this is Joe Namath, and I'm throwing a flag on those misleading attacks on the new West Side Stadium. If you're like me, you believe New York City always deserves the best. Let's face it, we've got it all, including the best fans. Still, there's one thing we don't have, a world-class sports and convention center. But with the new West Side Stadium, all New Yorkers will have a reason to cheer. Here's something for everyone. New conventions, World Cup soccer, trade shows, who knows, maybe even the Olympics. For New York, that means more business, more jobs, and millions of new visitors. But here's the best part. My team, the New York Jets, pay $800 million, and the stadium generates millions in new revenue for schools and hospitals and firefighters. You know, there's only one way winning the Super Bowl could have been better. If we had won at home in New York City, well, with your help, we're going to play a Super Bowl right where it belongs, in the greatest city on earth.
Support the Far West Side Sports and Convention Center at www.nycolympicstadium.com. Paid for by New York Jets.
Six on the fan. Joe Beningo with you here on the overnight show. 718-937-6666 is the phone number. Tommy on the track, the trail, is on the fan. How are you, Tom?
Hey, Joe, what's up, buddy?
You tell me, baby, what's happening?
Listen, I agree with you that the law firm of Leiter, Glavin, and Franco have got to go. But because they're behind more of this trouble that we're in than anything. But I got a bull. Do you have something personal against Piazza? Because all he is a superstar in decline.
I know
he's
that.
He's been a good soldier, and he's meant more to this franchise than these three banana heads could ever mean.
Well, I don't disagree with that, Tom, but I just think that right now, you know, they'd be better served if they could move him to the American League and, you know, go from there. Because, you know, what is he anymore? He can't be the focal point of the offense anymore. You know what I'm saying?
I don't disagree with you, but you can't lump him in with those guys because He's not the troublemaker that they are.
No, you're right. No, Tommy, that's fair. I should not lump him in that way. You're right. He's not a clubhouse lawyer. You're right about that.
And you never read anything bad about this guy.
No, that's a fair statement, Tom. And I shouldn't lump him in with those guys. Even though I want to see him go, I think it's time for him to go. You're right. He's not one of these guys who's a politician in the locker room. I don't think he's a guy who's going to Wilpon and, you know, telling him what he wants done. And he was even the guy who, a couple of years ago, if you remember, who actually wanted Gary Sheffield on his team when Wilpon was saying that he was a cancer in the clubhouse.
Yeah, I got one quick question.
Yeah.
What do you think's going to happen today with Hal?
Boy, I don't know. They're so screwed up, Tom, I don't know.
They can't even fire a guy right.
Tell me about it. I know. For all I know, they might come out today and say, how's the manager for the rest of the year and next year? Right? Would that shock you, Tom?
Oh, but you, Tom.
Would that shock you with this franchise?
No. This is sad.
It really is.
All right, Joe.
Tommy, be well. It really is a bad... It's just so badly run. It's incredible. It's just such a badly run franchise. You know, who knows what's going to happen today? Who knows? Maybe they are going to do that. Maybe they are going to retain Hal for the rest of the year and bring him back next year, too. Would that really shock anybody? 718-937-6666. Jim in East Meadow is on the fan. How are you, Jim?
Joe, it is absolutely my pleasure to be on your show right now.
Well, the pleasure's all mine, Jim.
First of all, the Jets look incredible. The defense... if you've been a Jet fan, it looks like a Ferrari versus like a Volkswagen.
Hey, that's a very good analogy. You're right. You're right.
Okay, the speed is there, and, you know, it's just like the offense is there. I'm feeling it, Joe.
Well, Jim, I I've been a Jet fan, and thanks for the call. Get back to me because we've got to run here at the end of the show. I've been a Jet fan too long, and I've been burned too many times. So I'm enjoying this win. I'm taking it one game at a time. Go out and beat the Chargers this weekend. We'll go from there. Want to thank all the callers. Great job, as always. Could not do without you. Terrific job by Jerry Recco and Sugar Ray Martel. The 530 News, this report is brought to you by Volvo. Excellent savings and are still available now on all 2004 models at your Volvo retailers. Hurry into your local Volvo retailer before September 30th to take advantage of these great 2004 model year-end opportunities. And now here with the news, Mr. Charles McCord.
Top of the news this morning, slowly but inexorably, Hurricane Ivan is moving through the Gulf of Mexico, headed right for the Panhandle coastline area from Grand Isle, Louisiana, to Apalachicola, Florida. That's about a 300-mile stretch of land where this storm could make a possible landfall. More than 3 million people have been told to get to higher ground, including lots of late-season vacationers. Earl Thomas of Savannah, Georgia, didn't want to stay.
We were expecting to stay down for the full week, but it's cut us short, and we're heading back fully exhausted.
The National Hurricane Center is warning that Ivan could strengthen as it nears land. At last report, top sustained winds were still in the 140-mile-an-hour range, making it a rough Category 4 storm. New Orleans, which is about 8 feet below sea level, is virtually a ghost town, as most residents have made the decision that it would be best to get out. Hurricane Ivan is not only threatening to cause widespread destruction to the Gulf Coast, it's also leading to a sharp increase in oil prices. As energy companies shut down refineries and offshore oil rigs, world oil prices took a sharp turn upwards. U.S. light crude up 30 cents to $44.69 a barrel. The government is poised to write another big check to pay for all the hurricane-related damage in the South and for drought aid to Midwest states as well. President Bush has asked Congress for an additional $3.1 billion to help Florida and other states recover from the recent storms. Despite facing record deficits, the Senate has also given bipartisan approval to nearly $3 billion in drought aid. The State Department is diverting $3.4 billion in U.S. funds from Iraqi water and power projects in an effort to boost security, oil output, and jobs creation instead. Officials hope refocusing rebuilding efforts will create a more stable environment. Under the plan, the U.S. will put an additional $1.8 billion into security and law enforcement, $450 million into oil output, and $286 million into job creation. The plan also includes $180 million for democracy and governance initiatives.
$380 million more for economic development and $360 million for debt reduction. Air traffic is again flowing relatively smoothly after a radio communications glitch at a control center in Southern California prompted the FAA to order a ground stop. For almost 3.5 hours, all flights bound for airports in the region were held at other airports while the problem was being addressed. Air traffic controllers lost radio contact with aircraft flying at high altitudes within a 200-mile radius of Palmdale, California, just outside Los Angeles. An FAA spokesperson said the Air Traffic Control Center could see the aircraft on radar but could not contact them. On the stump yesterday, President Bush addressed the National Guard Association in Las Vegas amid controversy over his own Texas Guard service of the early 70s. Mr. Bush didn't directly speak to the controversy, but did mention his service in the Guard.
As the general just said, you've had many famous Americans in your ranks, including men named Jefferson, Madison, Lincoln, and Truman. 19 individuals have served both in the Guard and as President of the United States, and I'm proud to be one of them.
The flap over the president's contested National Guard service is far from over. The Dallas Morning News reports today that the former secretary for the Texas Air National Guard officer who allegedly wrote these memos critical of Bush's service has come out also to say the documents are fake. However, Marion Carr Knox says the documents would suggest somebody was applying pressure to so-called sugarcoat the president's record, Mr. Bush's record, mirror ones that actually existed and that the contents are pretty accurate. Despite all that, the Bush-Cheney campaign continues to roll. Former Mayor Rudy Giuliani was in Missouri last night campaigning for Mr. Bush's re-election. Giuliani said that the president has a strong record of leadership and of sticking to his positions, and that's one clear difference, he said, between the president and Democratic hopeful John Kerry.
He's been pro-war, anti-war, pro-war, voted against the Persian Gulf War, then said he supported the Persian Gulf War. So on these very, very important matters of war and peace, the Patriot Act, he voted for it, now he's against it. NAFTA, he voted for it, now he's against it. He's changed his position so often, but I think the American people feel that he doesn't have the kind of consistency that you need in a leader.
Locally, in the Democratic congressional primaries of yesterday, Representative Major Owens beat back a challenge by two city council members who were looking to oust him. He received 44% of the vote. The congressional district that Owens represents is overwhelmingly Democratic. Congressman Elliot Engel was declared the winner of his primary, and Representative Charlie Rangel received 71% of the vote in his primary. iSports, Yankees won, beat the Royals, shut them out 4-0 as the Red Sox were losing. Mets over the Braves 7-0. And we'll have the details coming up. Mostly cloudy, 70s today, 62 degrees right now at 35 minutes past the hour.
On The Late Show with David Letterman, known as Jada Pinkett Smith, and musical guest Jessica Simpson. The Late Show with David Letterman, only on CBS.
So, I hear these ads for DeFabe.
Three, the Twins beat the White Sox 10-2. The Mariners 3, Angels 2, and the Rangers knocked off the A's 12-9. According to a published report on Sportsline.com, the New Jersey Nets and Portland Trailblazers are in discussions about a possible trade involving Jason Kidd for Sharif Abdur-Rahim. The Detroit Lions make it official. Wide receiver Charles Rogers out the rest of the season with a broken collarbone. Panthers wide receiver Steve Smith underwent successful surgery on his broken leg. He's expected to be out at least 8 to 10 weeks. The Eagles signed Dorsey Levens. World Cup of Hockey, Canada beat Finland 3-2. The CBA and the NHL runs out at midnight tonight, so the impending lockout looks like it's going to happen. And in the WNBA, the Shock beat the Liberty in overtime 82-71. This report brought to you by Subway, a regular 6-inch classic tuna sandwich for $1.99 at participating Subway restaurants. For a limited time, $1.99 for the classic tuna sandwich at Subway. And that's sports. I'm Jerry
Reckner. I don't want nobody's kiss if it's not from
the morning. BMW's pinnacle of service is the center of excellence.
EB Games and Electronics Boutique, they take games seriously. I'm Tracy Burgess with the Packet 8 video phone, Van Highway Patrol.
Please welcome to the I, Miss Lemoyne program, one of our favorite people, one of mine anyway, Denise Austin. How are you?
I'm great.
Good morning, Miss Austin.
Good morning, honey.
Sit up nice and tall. Feel good, everybody. Come on, it's a beautiful day.
You know, you're, as you get a little age on you, you're starting to look a little better.
Ooh, thank you, Harvey.
You think that's good?
Yeah, that's very good.
Like my wife. I think my wife's better looking now than she was when
she
I married
awesome.
Her.
She looks awesome. She's beautiful. Oh. And I love her new book. I've even tried some of your recipes.
Yeah?
I love it, yeah. The potato chowder my kids love.
So you're a big Bush supporter, right?
Absolutely.
I had 41 on this show. Did you see that?
I did.
He was great, wasn't he?
Oh, I missed when he was on, but everyone told me he was awesome.
Yeah, he really was.
And you were really great to him. He's a wonderful person.
Well, what was I going to do?
Well, come on. You're the high man.
Well, no, but I mean, no, but I wouldn't be rude to him.
That's
I mean,
right. He is the was the president of the United States.
Yeah, he answered all the questions, and he was
wonderful. He's an awesome person.
Some friend of mine told me, some liberal communist friend of mine told me, he said, you know, that guy should still be president, so.
Oh, that would be nice.
Supposed to his, well, who are you going to vote for? I mean, who?
Of course, Bush.
Yeah, but I mean, how, you can't vote for him.
Well, what has Kerry done? Honestly,
I
what
I didn't say
done?
You vote for him either.
All right, then. What do we got?
I don't know. It's trouble.
I love Bush. There's a few things I don't understand, but I do love him. And I think he's a great president. He's a great leader.
You know, I told somebody yesterday, I think I probably told Bernard, and Bernard just looked at me like I was a fool. I said, well, you know, the only thing you could hope with George Bush is that if he actually wins this election, I mean, actually wins
which
it,
he will.
As opposed to the last one, which he obviously didn't win, but they gave to him, if he would, or whatever, and then maybe he would feel more legitimate and wouldn't feel intimidated into hiring all these war criminals who, unfortunately, were with his, in his father's administration, or his father could control, by the way, and maybe would, because I actually don't think George. Like, I'm not one of those people who hates George Bush.
Good.
At all.
Great.
And actually, I think he's a good person, but I think he's gotten some horrible advice that he's unfortunately taken. And that comes from people like Senator John McCain, who, by the way, is one of the most extraordinary people on the planet.
Yeah.
And I've been around
Arizona,
him.
Yay.
No, he's just a great American. He's a great person, isn't he, Charles?
Yes.
Unbelievable.
I mean, we were just stunned,
as we said.
Because it's not an act with him. You know, you can,
oh,
I mean, I've been
real.
Around a while. I know when I'm getting my chain jerked by somebody. And
you won't believe who's my good friend. You talk to him.
Just give me a hint.
Okay.
Gary Condit.
Who?
Gary Condit.
No, Tracy Gershon. Who you talk to all the time.
Oh, Tracy Fitzsony.
Yeah. I've known her for over 30 years. Can you believe it?
I met her, I became a fan of hers.
Watching Nashville
Star. Watching Nashville Star.
Yeah.
And she's a record executive at Sony.
That's right.
And I email her occasionally. And her husband's some big
producer
and musician. And
right.
She really is a neat lady, isn't she?
She's awesome.
Yeah.
We've had the best times.
Yeah.
Her best friend is Mary Jane, who's my best friend. So it's wonderful.
I'll be darned. How did you?
Small world, huh?
You ass.
What?
Well, Justin, you can show a little bit more interest in that.
Well, because she knows I'm jerking her chain.
No,
I hate
remember when I tried to, you know, remember when I first met you, I thought, boy, this is here is somebody who is really a dope. Don't you remember?
Yes, and you questioned me. You said, okay, who's the Secretary of Defense?
And it turns out you live next
William
door to
William Perry, my next door neighbor.
Yeah, yeah,
no. That was going back.
I was foolish, what of me, but
I'll put you there.
Yeah. So how are you?
I'm great. Everything's
how's your
great.
Husband?
He's fabulous.
How are the kids? How old are your kids
my
now?
My two daughters. One just turned 14. Kelly's the oldest. We just had a big 14th birthday party for her. A boy-girl dance party.
Yeah.
And then my little one's 10. She's really cute.
So I was just talking to Lupica. You know Mike Lupica?
Of course. I know of him. I don't know him personally.
Yeah, I was just talking to him yesterday. Do you know that Christopher is 17 years old, Charles?
Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
I know. It's shocking.
How old is Wyatt? Six?
He's 41.
Wyatt, your little boy. July 3rd is his birthday, right?
Yes.
I remember. July 23rd is yours.
Yes. When's Deirdre's?
Oh, gosh. You never told me that one.
August 4th.
Oh, gosh.
She's
a Leo.
August 4th, 1984. So,
good. 84.
That silly man. 94.
I heard that one.
You
have a new book out. Sculpt your body with balls and bands. Have you ever tried one of the fitness balls, the
yes,
stability balls?
My wife uses them.
Yes, they're fabulous. There's over 100 different exercises.
My wife has a stomach like yours, by the way.
Oh, I know. She's
maddening.
In great shape.
Yeah.
I'm proud of her.
But she works at it all the time.
Yeah, we all have to. That's all about taking good care of yourself. Good health is so important. You know, we only have one life. You got to take, you know.
Oh, you know, I forgot to mention, because we went to Walter Reed yesterday, and I forgot about everything else.
Right.
Now, ordinarily, I'd have spent the entire morning talking about my PSA, because I went to see Darkot Vaughn, who, along with, what's the other guy's name?
Patrick Walsh.
Patrick Walsh.
Down at Johns Hopkins.
I know there are lots of good urologists, but...
But these are two of
Johns
the very...
Hopkins.
These are two of the very
yes.
best.
But Dr. Vaughn, Dr. Vaughn is in the same league as Richard Matthey at Yale.
Oh, yeah.
Culinary
right.
guy.
Yeah.
And the same kind of person, too,
right.
by the way.
Yep.
My, so I thought I was hovering near death last spring because my PSA went up to 4.1, which is not high for my age.
Right.
But it's the rate of, as everybody from Rudolph Giuliani, on up or down.
Yeah.
Up, or down, rather.
So what is it?
Well, let me get to it.
Okay.
Can we have a drum roll, please?
So, but I'd spent 3 months on a horse, and I, right. you know, I mean, I wasn't just like, you know, you ride 5 hours a day at the ranch,
you're
and there's only yeah. 6 or 7 days you have off during the entire summer. So, so I got on this stuff called Halen 951, which is this 4 minutes.
Wait a minute. Explain the significance of being on the horse.
Oh, that can raise your PSA level.
Thank you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All the jarring so, around there?
Nonsense.
Well, I don't know what it is. That's just what Dr. Vaughn told me. Same with riding a bicycle.
Okay.
So I got on this Halen 951, which is fermented soy.
Oh.
It's the most putrid stuff.
You have to drink it?
Yeah. It's you can't imagine how horrible it is.
Oh.
But David said, try this stuff. And there have been some data suggesting some dramatic results in
great.
Raising your white blood cell count, mm-hmm. raising your immune system, and even combating
good.
Cancer, so, and reducing your PSA. So,
great.
Although, well, we'll see. So I just had it checked again. It's down to 3.0.
Whoa, good work.
Now,
in 3-4
that
months.
Is absolutely nothing going up down there.
down over a point in 3 months.
That's wonderful.
Having, that probably is lower than that, actually. Now, see, I haven't talked to Dr. Vanya, so I don't know if it's we can attribute it to the, but it's diet because I eat.
Yeah, a lot of it is diet.
So I don't
did
eat any meat, any
fish,
any chicken.
Level checked?
Because, 129.
Woo, that's awesome. It's September is National Cholesterol Education Month.
My LDL is like 70-something. My HDL is around 55 or 6 or 7
excellent.
Or 60.
I'm on a Take Heart campaign for women to try to get women to find out what their cholesterol level is because it can be in your family history, so that's very important. Like my girlfriend, Mary Jane, who's good friends with Tracy, she's fit like I am. She works out every day. I mean, she eats so healthy, but yet because of her mom, she had high cholesterol. So she went in, she got her cholesterol in check with some medication, but it's key that everyone checks their cholesterol.
What's yours?
Mine is 168.
So that's a lot.
No, that's natural for me. It's 160. And I eat well. I exercise. But I think that's
do you eat meat?
I'm in the healthy range.
Do you eat meat?
Do I? Once in a while.
Organic meat?
Organic meat.
Okay,
I
want to
buy
okay.
organic meat. Organic
or do you eat fish?
Eggs. Twice a week I eat fish.
That's a death sentence. Why don't you just drink arsenic? Really, I mean, it's so full of mercury.
Well,
the government.
I get fresh stuff.
Is Bull Shoals Lake one of the lakes on the list?
No, it's got to be fresh water.
A fish full of
no.
mercury?
No.
Good, okay.
But also, it's good to take some fish oil supplements. That's very important.
Bordino's got some of his own
yeah.
fish oil, but
oh.
David checked it out. Well, it's icky.
Oh, it is. Did you know that it's the number one killer for women, heart disease?
I didn't know that until
yeah.
I started reading this Hackensack Boy, University
yeah.
Medical Center.
And,
we were stunned.
And
yeah.
it has a lot to do with exercise, eating right. You have to eat right. And if you have to go to the doctor and find out, it's very important to find out your cholesterol because it's a key. Did you know there's a rumor that Clinton wasn't taking his statin when he had that heart problem?
He had
gone off
his medication.
Of it. He didn't take
arbitrarily.
His so, I mean, this is why it's so important. Wow. Why not do the best you can for your health and
well,
your
thank
heart?
Thank God President Clinton's okay, don't you agree?
Oh, yes,
yes,
definitely.
Absolutely.
Yes, I'm so glad he went in and got it fixed, and he'll be feeling great now, as long as he exercises. They have to exercise, like, up to an hour.
He got it fixed. He had his heart worked on.
Right.
Well, what's this working out with balls you're doing?
I knew you would tease me,
talking
Bernard.
Denise Austin.
Balls and bands.
Denise's new book.
I even brought the bands with me, honey.
Let me find that chapter.
I'm a in the morning.
File folders?
Yeah.
What about...